you've got Cam Pedersen, who'll start in the ruck against big boy McAvoy. Hawks to the city end. Triple MCG. Cold afternoon for McDonald's. Triple M rocks footy. Nice bounce. Slightly favours McAvoy. Got it down. Biney, fall of the ball. Lewis sockers it off the ground. Birchall does the same. Doesn't go anywhere. Falls to half forward. Biney got it moving forward. Petrarca pushed off the ball by Gibson, the man that Duck spoke about. Hodge has been there for a long time. Scrubs a bouncing ball to the outer half-back flank.
Melbourne pick it up immediately. Big tackle applied on Salem on the outer wing. Now comes to Mitchell. Leading possession winner for the Hawks this year. Goes to Gunston, who shorts it to Rioli. Back in the side. Cyril got the green boots on. Goes one further short to Langford. He's delayed inclusion. O'Meara out of the side with a sore knee. Not the knee, though, according to Brett Ratton. He told us on the Sunday Rub pre-game. Now Gunston's got it. Southern stand side. He's been called to play on. The Hawks going short. This time he drives it longer down the line. Big fly from Sicily. He's got strong hands and takes a good mark on the outer wing.
Keen to move it on quickly. Chisels the ball to Rioli. Edge of the square. Half forward, out of side.
That was Big O'Brien, I think, there, Howie. Great mark.
Courage shown by Hunt. Got in the way of McAvoy. Bruce, or Shields, I should say, comes flying through. Goes to ground heavily. Lewis, the tackle on Puopolo. And we'll have it thrown up 40 out from the Hawks' goal.
That's a really good confidence booster for O'Brien. That's a really strong pack mark. Kick down the line. He'll get a lot of confidence out of that. Good mark early for him.
He's had a good couple of weeks now. Forced a rough head. Hooks it back in the middle of the ground. Langford tracks it back. Takes a good mark. Only about 15 out on a tight angle for the late inclusion to go back and have a shot for the first goal of the game.
Well, you often see guys, Howie, they get a late call-up, mm-hmm. and then they perform, and he's got a really good chance here to make sure that he stays in the side.
Will Langford bending it around the corner. He's got a lot of height on it.
Oh, he's muffed
it. Not a good effort. He did muff it, Duck. Just snuck it through for one behind. He really muffed it.
Already we're seeing the Hawks go into their uncontested marking game. Five uncontested marks already, so looks like they're going to adopt that style of play, which has been their trademark over the last 5 or 6 years.
If Langford does have a weakness, it's his kicking efficiency. His career, he goes at 45%. So that's why he's in and out of this side at the moment.
Kennedy Harris takes the mark. The kick from Jenner. Later handball off to Lewis. Goes to the broadcast wing. Garlett's there. Strat marks him closely. Watt steps it out of bounds. Right in front of the Hawks bench. And we'll have it tossed in. Early stages opening term. 2.5 gone. On the Triple M Beaumont Tiles scoreboard, the Hawks by a point.
Played a brilliant grand final for the Hawks, Langford. Kicked goals, yep, kicked a couple of good ones from the pocket.
Didn't get a game the year after, did he?
No, since then he has struggled a bit, Duck, and as you say, his turnover possessions hurts him a little bit. Nathan Jones tracks it back towards the boundary, straight in front of Robbo, and it goes across that boundary. The Hawks are just one behind. Melbourne yet to score. Round the grounds, up in Sydney. How many's Bud got? What's the score, thanks, Chew?
Bud's got 7 majors, and he's lining up for his 8th, but it's the Swans by 54 points over Brisbane, early stages, final quarter.
McAvoy and Pedersen came into the side last week and did well in the ruck. Izzy Smith throws a boot at it, can't get it clear. Now there's a chance for Vince. First real opportunity for Melbourne. Burnie takes a bounce and is charged down by Puopolo. It's a wobbly kick. Burton gets tangled up with Hogan, but now comes to Jordan Lewis. Tries to just slide one inside 50, but he was tight for room, and in the end sends it out on the full, and Stratton will bring it back in for the Hawks. In fact, it could be Birchall.
So last line of defence. It'll be Stratton defending the city end of the Triple MCG. Small crowd, Ash.
They've averaged 39,000 from their past four. I reckon we're probably about 35.
Mitchell called to play on. Gave a handball to Burgoyne. Burton, he'll get it again from Hodge. Good run from the kid through the middle of the MCG square. Got a man out wide. It's the skipper. Roughhead forward at the outer wing. Chipping ball to Rioli. Promising build-up. Keen to move it on, Cyril. He'll punch the ball. Low ball. Langford got in the way of his teammate. Loose ball. Jetter. Good tackle on him by O'Brien. And then they come in numbers. Langford involved. And we'll have it thrown up 15 out from Hawthorn's goal. They lead by point.
Rioli scissor one inside 50, but Langford chopped off a ball that wasn't meant for him. So only 20 out from the Hawks' goal. They've started reasonably well. O'Brien in the ruck. Can't really get it clear. Oliver does. So good at ground level. Now Salem just belts it outside of inside 50. Marking contest. Have a look at this man, Petrarca. He's big and he's strong and he takes a contested mark. Immediately plays on back to Oliver. He sweeps it inboard to Jordan Lewis, who shorts the ball. Gives the Hawks an opportunity through Birchall. Tracks the ball back. The Hawks have got the numbers here, and they should get clear, but Hodge fumbles. Gives Pedersen a chance. Now Garlett, bouncing ball. Gibson's tracking all the way back and will stop it like a goalkeeper in the goal square.
Lewis's numbers for Bosch Tools.
Three touches.
Marked by Birchall.
Geez, Gallard had Nathan Jones running past him too for a handball. Looked like it was going to be a relatively easy shot for Nathan. Maybe he didn't see him, give him the benefit of the doubt.
Hawks by point. Five gone opening term. Triple M Beaumont Tile scoreboard. Beaumont, your one-stop shop for tiles and bathroom wear. Hodge drops a long ball to the outer wing. McAvoy camped underneath it. Clean set of hands.
Only one that went for it, Swatter.
Yep, which makes marking easy, Duck. So Big Boy will put it down the line. Goes towards Roughhead. Got rid of his man, but Frost takes an easy mark at halfback.
So Frost, a little bit unsure what to do, so he chips on the right boot. It's going to work out okay, although it doesn't, because Salem and Oliver spoil each other. Gives Puopolo a chance. He goes to Gunston, approaching 50. Slides one inside 50, and O'Brien takes a good diving mark. As you said, Duck, his confidence is up from a big contestant mark early. He's about 30 out, but tight on the boundary line, Tim O'Brien.
I'm going to keep an eye on this one, but I think Tommy McDonald, Duck, is playing in the ruck at the moment. I think you've got Oscar McDonald and Sam Frost down back, and it looks like Tommy McDonald's running around with McAvoy, but I'll keep an eye on that.
So Tim O'Brien to line up to kick the first of the match. Crosses the boundary line now. The number 23, famous at Hawthorn. Gee, it's a good-looking kick off the boot. It's an absolute beauty from a tight angle to get things underway. O'Brien bags his first of the game and his fifth of the season. Hawthorn 1-1-7. Melbourne yet to score. Nice kick. Triple M Beaumont Tiles scoreboard. Beaumont's your one-stop shop for tiles and bathroom wear.
Yes, a man many, many years ago. Gun centre-half forward had... the famous number 23, and he had the red hair too, but dyed it blonde. Bruzy, you now work alongside him on a Thursday night. It is a very, very famous number, and he's off to a good start. And it started with that contested mark on the outer side, and then that diving mark. And if you're going to go to ground, you wrap him up, and that's exactly what the kid did. And, geez, that's a nice kick from that position too, from the boundary.
Yep, all class. Hooks get the opening goal, lead by 7 points for McDonald's. Triple M rocks footy. Tyson tries to squeeze a handball through. D's have numbers. Oliver was one. Aaron Hamble. Jones gets it to Vince. Good swarming pressure from the Hawks. Underground handball towards Jones, but three Hawks converge. And the quickest man through the corridor, that was Smith. Left foot high ball. Goes inside 50. McDonald's there. So is Frost. Under some real heat here, the Melbourne defenders, but they have Hibbard with possession. Clean hands, got it to Bernie Vince. Hurried kick. Ball needs to bounce favourably. Pitches just inside the field of play. Is that deliberate? It is. No. Got away with one. Throw in half forward.
Now, Tom McDonald is coming off the wing, so he's starting on the wing. Pedersen starting in the centre bounce, and now Tom McDonald goes into the ruck. So he is playing in the ruck today, Tommy McDonald.
The Hawks have got the only goal of the game through O'Brien. It's deep in the Demons' defensive zone. Tyson needs to be good, and he's really good by hand. Gives it to Geordie Lewis, and the Demons have got a chance on the wing. They go short. The mark can't be taken, but they mop up nicely. Pedersen just hoofs the ball forward towards Salem. He can't get the loose ball. Neither can Howe, though. More Hardwick trying to get hands on the footy, and it spins out towards the Demons.
Yep, Pedersen's gang tackled Hodge. Loops the handball over the top to Smith. Fired one to Mitchell. Doesn't want to kick it, so he gives it back by hand to Smith. Wheels around onto the favoured left foot boot. Drops it towards Ruffid. Coming across the top was Oscar McDonald. Gets a pat on the head from Frost. Ball goes out of bounds. 45 around from Hawthorn's goal. They lead 1-1 to no score. 8.5 gone. Triple M Beaumont Tiles scoreboard.
He's got a good endurance, though, Tom McDonald, hasn't he?
Excellent endurance, yeah.
Ball spins back into play. Hawks dominating inside 50s at the moment. Triple M Bosch Tool stats.
6-3.
Now the Demons get an opportunity. Defensive side of the wing. It's a bit of a mung from Bernie Vince. Clean bowls Josh Gibson. Well, that could be in the back. Hardwick applying an illegal tackle, and the umpire agrees. So the free kick will go to Tommy Buck.
Just on the tackle.
Who's got just defensive side of the wing.
I think Hawthorn had about 8 for the whole game last week. About 8 already. So it's something that Brett Ratton spoke about before the game. They contested football and their tackle. So they're up already.
Finally with a big leap over the top. Couldn't take the mark. Ball goes out of bounds. And it was out on the full. Seabus Super Special comments. The Zen Master Roozy alongside of the King Wayne Carey. Which between those two units is Ash. The Chew Man Chew Up. Very happy with a 69-point win yesterday, the Chew Man 2.
Talking about tackles, already Melbourne turning the ball over. So Hawks putting a lot of pressure on Melbourne.
Great kick from Hodge.
6-2, Duck.
And Hardwick inside the square. He's got a man running towards the outer wing. It's a bouncing ball, and it's greeted by Stratton. Handball off to Hartung.
Gives it to the running man, Billy. Goes long inside 50. Good ball. Mark dropped out there by one of the Hawks. It's Sicily. Couldn't quite get hands to it. Spilled it deep in the pocket. Now Melbourne, they come late in defence, and they do well through Hunt with the pink headband on. Now there's an opportunity for the Demons in the outer side of the ground.
Short ball to Hogan. Is that his first?
Spot on, spot on.
Chips it over the top.
Still running, Hunt.
This is better. And eventually Hunt will get it. He's a dasher. And then he delivers the ball over the top of Garlett and his direct opponent, mopping up momentarily. Burton got two Demons to contend with. Garlett keeps it alive. Got a handball off. Shot on goal is to the near side. In fact, it's out of bounds on the full. And I think it may be Hannon. So the D's yet to score. They trail Hawthorn by 7 points on the Beaumont Tiles scoreboard.
Ran 120 metres to get that ball, did Hunt?
Yeah.
I don't want to confuse him with Wagner, the number 42. He's got a very similar haircut and a similar headband. Now Hogan tries to slide one inside 50. Doesn't quite make it, but there is Hunt. Now he's popping it right to the top of the square. Pedersen battling away. Pedersen takes a good, strong mark. Push Burton out of the way. And Pedersen, who was tasty last week, will go back and have a shot from 15 out straight in front.
Yeah, and I know Pedersen's their third-string ruckman with Gorn Spencer, but I don't mind. He kicked goals at AFL level. He's kicked fours and fives.
And he can mark
the
ball.
And he can mark the ball.
When he's in form,
absolutely.
He's a really good mark of the footy, and he showed that there.
So Pedersen, he trots in directly in front to get the Demons first. No problem. Melbourne on the board. Lights on at the MCG. Hawthorn 1-1-7. Melbourne 1-6. 11.5 into the first term on your Triple M Beaumont Tiles scoreboard.
Jordan Lewis already having an impact too, man, isn't he?
Yeah, 7 touches, leading ball winner on the ground. And the contested ball starting to spread in Melbourne's favour.
Yeah, 16-10. Yeah, exactly. So, and I think this is probably Hawthorn's problem a bit too, Duck. Is a little period of dominance. Last year, the year before, would be 4-0.
Yeah.
Dominance, 1-1-0, and now 1-1-1. So they're just not able to capitalise on those periods of dominance that they were over the last 5 or 6 years.
Yeah, that's a great observation. You're right, because when they dominate like that, they've really put scoreboard pressure on you, don't they?
Seabus Super Special comments. The King and the Zen Master, nice bounce. Hawks by a point. Pedersen kicks their first Melbourne goal. Good follow-up tackle in the middle of the centre circle by Bernard Vince, and we'll have it thrown up. Round the grounds.
Round the grounds. Sydney leading Brisbane by 61 points. Buddy with 7 goals.
Calling it, Ash.
Yes, what up.
Yeah, it's a safe bet now. It's been a big day by the Swans. Their first win at the end of round 7. Charging onto a loose ball. McDonald, that was Tom. Pedersen in everything. He runs into an opponent for Hawthorn. Ball still alive. Hannon tries to flick a handball out. Mitchell, the former Swan, gets in the way. Coming after him, Kennedy Harris. Good physical contact on the outer wing from both teams and both players involved. And we'll have it thrown up just forward of the wing, outer southern side for the D's. They attack the punt road end and they trail by a point.
Sunshine out at the MCG. Breezy, cold day in Melbourne. The lights are on. Pretty chilly day today. Langford applies a tackle on Bernie Vince, southern stand wing. No one's going anywhere. One game still to start today, Chew.
Yeah, that's Fremantle taking on the Bombers. 4:40 start, Domain Stadium.
Nate Jones can't get a handle on it. Cyril Rioli can. He only needs a sniff, and he sends a really good pass to Gunston, who takes a good mark in front of Oscar McDonald. Gunston up and about early, drives it a long ball inside 50. Rough head. Did he push his opponent out? Umpire says no, he didn't. Roosie.
Wow. I know I'm ex-Melbourne coach. Duck, maybe I'll hand that one over to you. You're the centre forward.
Free kick.
Every day of the week.
Free kick. Obvious. Forearm into the middle of the back. Now, you're allowed to hold your ground with your forearm, but there was an actual pushing motion in that.
Rough head from 15 metres out, makes no mistake. The Hawks get their second. Hawthorn 2-1-13, Melbourne 1-6. The boys have had a look at it on the Triple M Chemist Warehouse replay screen.
Yeah, sure have. Chemist Warehouse replay screen clearly shows that Big Ruffy got away with one. And funnily enough, the umpire was in a pretty good position to pay that one too. So he may have thought that Ruffy just held his ground and there was no second motion in the push. But looking at the Chemist Warehouse replay screen, there was most certainly a, a push.
Spoil Mum this Mother's Day with a great range of fragrances at Chemist Warehouse, the real house of fragrances. Bob Jane, T-Marts, Mickey R.
Luke Hodge has just come back onto the ground. He's been off for about 3 or 4 minutes. I tell you what, he's a coaching paradise. He would never shut up. Instructions on the rotations, up to the coach's box. He's a ripper.
Robbo, thanks to Bob Jane, T-Marts. Puopolo charges onto a ball, drops it, goes back, gives it off by hand. Hartung got some time to wheel around over the logo on the outer wing. High ball, rough edge, the target. Getting up there was Frost. He had it cleanly and dropped the Gunston, the opportunistic goal. Hawks have got three. Capitalising on a bit of momentum, Hawthorn's way. 3-1-19, Melbourne 1 straight 6, 15 gone opening term, Triple M Beaumont Tiles scoreboard.
Well, this is exactly what you were talking about, Roosie. All of a sudden, bang, bang.
Yeah, and look, a couple of long kicks in, Duck, which is probably not their normal way to play, but I don't mind it. They've actually identified a couple of one-on-one contests. Firstly, it was Roughhead v. Frost, and then Frost dropped that mark there. But at least it's getting in quick. I like the Rioli start to the game too. He's got involved in the game too, man.
He has four disposals and a couple of entries inside 50.
Now he's going nuts down the front there. So he did make me make a mention of, he's got a Rioli sign. He said, Roosie mentioned Rioli. So I've got that out of the way early.
Well done. It's like a sponsor on this one.
Frost made a meal of that didn't he?
McDonald's rocking Triple M football on a Sunday afternoon. Burgoyne has a spell in the middle. He's wrapped up. Macca's new gourmet creations now available in drive-through. The fast, easy way to gourmet. Umpire's gone for a blood rule, so there's a Melbourne player coming from the ground. It's Jack Viney. Robbo will be all over that, Bob Jane T-Mart style. Jack Viney running towards you now, Robbo.
Yeah, just trying to pick that up. It's on the knee. It's on the right knee, a gash on the knee, yep.
13-point lead to the Hawks, 3-1, one straight. And the umpire will throw it up. McAvoy against Watts as Vince makes his way to the stoppage. For McDonald's, Triple M rocks footy. McAvoy got it down nicely. Shark by Shields, but a good tackle on him by Dom Tyson. And he's been rewarded.
Now, no prior opportunity, and it's a free kick against.
So work that out, Roosie, as Hibbard bullets the ball into the breadbasket of Christian Bull Petrarca. Barrel-chested lead, took it into the guts and took it well with a tumble roll. And Petrarca will go towards the pocket. Deep ball. Pedersen flies against Gibson. Loose ball. Bug keeps it alive. Coming through. Good work by Howe. Off to Stratton by hand.
He just pushes it outside 50 in hope and height. Big contest there. Melbourne player on the ground. He pops up now. It was Jetta. Meanwhile, the ball comes to Wagner, who gets it back. Back to Salem, who goes all the way back to Sam Frost in the middle of the ground, who chips it in to Nate Jones, who immediately switches to the outer side. Melbourne have a little bit of space if they can get it to Watts on the wing.
Yeah, Oscar McDonald delivers it to Watts. What are the numbers for Nate Jones?
He's only had two touches, and this is Watts' first.
So he's got it. Jack on the southern wing. Trail by 13. Almost 18 minutes gone of this opening turn. McDonald, Oscar takes the mark. Just a quiet hush. And McDonald will head down the line. And a good set of hands almost on that occasion from Clayton Oliver. Oliver, he's not happy, throws the ball into the drip tray and will have it tossed in. Right half forward flank, southern side, punt road end. And the D's trail Hawthorn by 13 points on the Beaumont Tiles scoreboard.
Follow this game on social media, hashtag AFLD's Hawks round the grounds.
Sydney by 47 points over Brisbane, 18 into the final quarter.
Buddy.
Seven majors.
Geordie Lewis.
He's racked up seven.
Okay, and gives it to the D's through Tyson. Looks to spot a ball inside 50. Really good ball. Garlett's on his own. And Jeffy can go back and have a shot. It was a good ball from Tyson. And Garlett will be kicking from about 48 metres. All about accuracy.
It's interesting that last stoppage. Jaden Hunt as a halfback came up to the back of the stoppage. I think it was O'Brien tried to tease him out. He didn't go with him and he impacted that contest. So they're going to have to keep an eye on that, the Hawks.
Kick 7-1 from set shots this year, Jeffy.
He's had a good season. Six matches, 15 goals. Right to the teeth of goals. And McAvoy is the only man down there that punches it through. Don't know where the Melbourne tall timber was. It's one behind Melbourne. They're seven. Hawthorn and 19. 19 into the first term on the Triple M Beaumont Tiles scoreboard.
Well, that's exactly where the big boy should be. The big ruckman, when you know a guy's right on his distance.
So the Bronx cheers for the former Demon, Chip Crawley. Now premiership player with the Hawks. Takes the mark in the back pocket. Heads long towards the outer wing. Good spoil. Tyson roving. Sidestep into trouble. Couldn't find a handball target. O'Brien gets in the way. Bernie Vince got a handball out to Jack Watts. Couldn't find the handball target because the pressure from Bruce was good. O'Brien got the handball off to the running man, Smith at half forward.
Rioli's on inside 50, but they just drive it all the way to the teeth of goals. 3-1 behind. Smith just missed to the near side. Hawthorn 3-2-20. Melbourne 1-1-7. Triple M Beaumont tiles scoreboard as Jones has got the ball at fullback.
Careless kick. Really careless kick from the co-captain. Picked off by Shields at half forward. 55 from home. Caresses a high ball. O'Brien will go with a big leap. McAvoy's there. Quick hands. Got it off to Bruce. Quick shot on goal. Classy finish. Hawthorn get there four. 4-2-26 to the Demons. 1-1-7. Beaumont Tiles scoreboard, Robbo, Bob Jane T-Marks.
As you can see, Melbourne are having to work their way to the punt road end and running into a little bit of a breeze. It's quite stiff and cold, actually, where the balls are tending to travel into half forward with Hawthorn.
Jeez, it was really poor by the Melbourne defenders here. I think they had five up, Duck. Five defenders. Just about every Melbourne defender flew for that ball against two Hawthorn forwards. And needless to say, if you don't mark it, there's got to be a free Hawthorn forward. Right. There was, and it was Luke Bruce kicking a relatively comfortable regulation goal for half forward.
And a really poor kick by Nat Jones too, wasn't it? You don't normally see that from him. That's another turnover. How many turnovers now for Melbourne?
Yeah, well, wait in favour of the Demons, Duck. It's 12-8.
McDonald's, Triple M, Rocks football. Jack Watts now having a crack in the ruck for the Ds. Kennedy, Harris, Langford. Caught in a tackle by Jack Watts, and the ball will be tossed up still in the centre square.
And just with the kicking efficiency, Melbourne only going at 56%, which is 10 below the league average. Hawthorn, they're tracking at 80.
Nicely done, Cheerman, for Bosch Tools. Good better Bosch. And the ball bobbles around. Clayton Oliver got a handball to Viney through heavy traffic somehow. Found a target by hand. Bernie Vince, high ball. Courage shown here. Good contest. Petrarca took down three Hawks. It was like a game of 10-pin bowling. Hodge, steady, calm and collected. Delivers the ball nicely by foot to Howe. Got a man working into some space off halfback. Shields, but the umpire says, Christian, no, Jordan. You've encroached. 50-metre penalty.
Stop 20 metres short of the end of the square.
And Melbourne have had 58 handballs, only 35 kicks.
So the ball goes inside 50 for the Hawks. In search of five. They currently lead by 19 points. Robbo, Bob Jane T-Martz.
Birchall on the outer wing, screaming for help. The physio's just got to him now in that heavy contest right side.
Mickey Roberts, dominating as always on a Sunday afternoon. McAvoy, 30 out from his attack and goal, gives it to Roughhead, walks through the pack. Mitchell hooks it round the corner, doesn't get enough bend on the banana. Sneaks through for one behind, well done by Ruffy though. Hawthorn 4-3-27, started positively. Melbourne 1-1-7, Triple M Beaumont tile scoreboard. What do you see on the Triple M Chemist Warehouse replay, Swatter?
Well, I saw the young bull, Kristen Petrarca, barrel-chested, bowls himself into Birchall, Gibson and Frawley. That explains why Grant Birch was a bit sore.
Could have nearly got a free kick for one round the neck too.
Gets the ball to halfback. Tommy Bug through traffic. Needs some clean possessions. Do they get it now? Viney just a handle into the path of Hannon. Shows a clean set of heels. Puts the ball up towards Petrarca. Good work by the Hawks defence. Hodge, it was. Hogan, no one there, Jesse. Tries to get boots a ball after an errant handball. Goes again. Good second attempt. Hardwick's in there as well as Viney. And they wrap each other up and we'll have it thrown up left half forward flank. Hawthorn 4-3, Melbourne 1-1, and that is on the Beaumont Tiles scoreboard.
Bob Jane T-Marts, Mickey Roberts, Birchall.
They've got to get him off the ground. He's struggling. He couldn't even get to that contest. They put him deep now, full back. He has to come off the ground.
Get the boy off, Robbo says. Ball to be won. Just forward of the wing for the Demons. Burgoyne directing traffic, but the umpire will have to come in and toss it up.
Well, Christian Petrarca here, Roosie, should recognise Grant Birchall's got an issue. Go to full forward and get some space.
Well, Birchall's trying to call Gibson back, I think. So Gibson's starting to come back now, but certainly limping Birchall.
Hibbard, handball, Oliver. They're under real heat here, the Ds. Good pressure from Hawthorn. Oliver, handball back. Wagner retreats. Good kick. Frees up Nev Jetta. What can he do? Chip it over the top to Tommy McDonald. Will want to give it back. Showed some candy.
Rioli works the mark. They're up to the task here, the Ds. They get it to the outer side to Oscar McDonald. Long driving ball inside 50. Good contest. Ball 40 from home for the D. Gets Hogan. Comes out like a steam train. But McAvoy is there. Hardwick needs to be careful. Gets rid of it. Isaac Smith will want to get it in front of himself. Pick it up and start running. He does that now. Back to Frawley. He goes very, very short to Josh Gibson, who will go even shorter back to Birchall, who's still out there. Let's see how he's moving. Seems to be going a little bit better now, Birchall. He's going to have to kick. He's called to play on. This will test him. He drives it down the line. He does look sore.
4 minutes to go. The opening term. Nice hands. Clean set of jukes from Nate Jones. Dees. Trail by 20. Jones to half forward. Sits up for Vince. And Hardwick read it well and drove his right knee into the guts of Bertie Vince. And he's hunched over on his all fours. In the meantime, Rioli's got a ton of space. Gathers a loose ball. Waits, watches, chipping ball. That's okay to Shields right in front of Robbo and Billy Hartung waiting to come back on.
Birch's staying out there. He must have got a corky by the look of him. He's jogging around, not at 100%. He might come to the bench now. Robbo will keep us updated as Billy Hartung takes a mark. Birch coming up, Robbo.
Yeah, I reckon he got a knock to the knee. Heavy knock, and he's frustrated. He's going straight down in the rooms too. He was screaming for help, and they finally recognise he's off the ground.
Hartung shows some can. He goes long inside 50 towards O'Brien. He can't take the mark. McAvoy gets second up to Langford. 30 from home. Dish it off a little hand pass. Hunt is there. Ball to be won. 30 out from the Hawks. Goals tight on the boundary line. And a couple of players get bundled across it. What's the umpire going to do here? Is he going to toss it in or pay a free kick as Grant Birchall goes straight down to the rooms? It's a free kick for a high tackle. And the Hawks, as a result, could well get a shot at goal. So it's Luke Bruce, who'd be kicking tight on the boundary line. Only about 20 out, though. Skillful operator. He's already got one Bruce. So he's facing directly away from the goals. He'll take two steps, three steps, swing it round. Bruce gets a nice bit of hook on it. A little bit too much. It's through for one behind. Hawthorn 4-4-28, Melbourne 1-1-7 on the Triple M Beaumont Tower scoreboard with Grant Birchall down in the rooms.
I think what a concern for Melbourne defensive coach is the number of Melbourne players that are flying for the mark in their back line. I tell you, the Hawthorn small forwards will be licking their lips if that keeps happening, because there's about three or four of them down and no one on them.
So they've got it at half back, the Deets. Handball comes from Wagner. Goes to Bernie Vince, who's had a bit of it.
He has seven touches.
Heads down the line to Salem. Follow the ball, Viney. Slick handball. Got it to the dasher. That was Hunt. He was well tackled. Viney goes again. Got a handball. It was a hot one to Petrarca. Shields gets a boot in there. Got it to his former teammate, Lewis. Eventually, Bernie Vince, another Bosch tool possession. Good switch. Got Nate Jones inside the square.
Bit of a blue on down in front of Robbo. We'll get to that shortly. Jones, the ball run. Spears one inside 50, but he hits Langford on the chest. He takes a good pressure relieving mark. Gibson will immediately distribute the ball by foot to the outer side. And the Hawks through Hardwick go further down the wing to Smith. Puts out one claw, takes the mark, immediately plays on and drives it long.
Yeah, spears the ball to rough head over the top, paddled it to ground, got it towards Bruce. Thought he might have been ridden into the back, not according to the umpire. The D's pile in. Lewis is there as well as Hibbard. In fact, we'll have it thrown up. 4-4 to 1-1. Hawthorn lead, Triple M Beaumont Tile Scoreboard.
What's the handball to kick ratio for Melbourne at the moment, two men?
77 handballs to 46 kicks.
Whenever I watch Melbourne, Roosie, and they have more handballs than kicks, they're struggling. And that's exactly what they're doing again today.
Ball down the wing. Robbo, keep an eye on Sicily. We've seen a couple of replays on the Triple M Chemist Warehouse replay of him. A bit concerned about a shoulder. Not sure if he's still on the bench. Now Hodge picks it up. Wanted to go long, but eventually shorts it to Langford. Bob Jane Teamart, Sicily still on the bench?
The physio and the doctor had a look at him. He's got full movement in the shoulders now. He's just sitting here ready to come back on.
So Langford's got it on the outer wing. Full time at the SCG. We'll go to that score shortly. Two man loose ball inside forward 50 for Hawthorn. Good start by the Hawks. Hodges waiting. Charging through the other way was a tearaway Hunt. Free kick going the Demons' way.
Now Melbourne's way for a throw.
No, against the D's. Well picked up, Duck. It'll go Hawthorn around the grounds.
Yes, that's full time. Sydney by 54 points. 2015-135. Brisbane 12-9-81. Buddy Franklin with eight majors. His highest return since round 21, 2014.
Good day for Buddy. End of round seven. Sydney get a win. Can you believe that? They get their first win at the end of round seven. Hibbard's careless kick. It's just a nothing kick, and he puts it out of bounds on the full.
Another. Does that count as a turnover? Is that when you just kick it out on the full? Because
yes,
it is a turnover.
It does.
Kicking efficiency, Tune.
Yeah. 61%.
Burton drives it along. McAvoy with a big contested mark. Big Benny marks. Only about 10 out on a reasonably tight angle. But you'd imagine he should pop it through. Hawks lead 28-7.
Well, Roosie, you've been saying all day that they've either had too many up or on that occasion, no one up.
It's a big concern, and the long ball comes in, and the Demons certainly aren't dealing with it at the moment very well at all.
It's not a lay down for McAvoy. As I said, he'll only kick from about 10, 12 metres, but it is a 45-degree angle. Hawthorn currently lead by 21 points. That was the siren in the background. McAvoy kicks it right through the middle. Good first turn by the Hawks. Hawthorn 5-4-34. Melbourne 1-1-7. A 27-point lead to Hawthorn at quarter time. For McDonald's, Triple M rocks footy. Hawthorn have started well. Hawthorn 5-4-34. Melbourne 1-1-7. The Hawks by 27 points at quarter time. Pretty chilly here. So much so that Schwatter's got the poo brown beanie on it after he said as we go down. Bob Jane T. Martin, is there a fitness test out there, Robbo?
Straight away, just come up. Heavily, heavy strap on the right side, on the right knee. So he's had a bad knock, but also might have done some damage there. They had two doctors and a physio down for Grant Birchall down in the rooms. As you can see, Howie running along the wing here, really sore and proppy. Both sides, posterior and, medial and lateral side, but really heavily bandaged on that right side. Big fitness test for the number 14.
Yeah, he looked disappointed when he came off, and I'm sure that's a reflection that he's missed already a lot of footy this season. Paul Ruse, Wayne Carey, back row.
Yeah, I think clangers have been a big issue for the Demons. They've had 10 clangers to 3, and we're just talking about their kicking efficiency has been really low. Nathan Jones is probably their best kick and best decision makers at 25% kicking efficiency. And just as I said, Duck, that Hawthorn hadn't taken advantage of their inside 50s, they kicked the next 4 goals. So they've certainly come out of that first quarter very, very nicely.
Yeah, for Melbourne, as you said, turnovers, kicking efficiency, and handballing the footy far too much in comparison to kicks. 78 handballs to, what is it, 38 kicks.
Yep, yep.
I mean, that's just out of whack. And that's allowing Hawthorn to put them under extreme pressure, because some of those handballs are given to players under more pressure than what they are. So, yeah, therefore, Hawthorn getting the turnovers and making them pay.
And 23 tackles, too, I think, to the Hawks. I think they had 44 last week in total.
Yep.
So, that's a good start.
Hey, Robbo, Birchall walked towards you, takes his place on the bench. What's your feel right now?
Doubtful. Swat, yep. Real doubtful that with way. That knee. Yeah, really. And disappointed, too. How he was right. He hated coming off.
Summed up beautifully, Robbo, because that's what we saw on the Triple M Chemist Warehouse replay screen. Free kick going to the Demons, and it will go to Tommy McDonald, broadcast wing, early stage of second term for McDonald's. Triple M rocks footy. Sums up their day, kicks into the man on the mark. There's Tommy, paddles it back to his brother Oscar, waits for Ruff to come. A terrific tackle, loose ball swooped on by Langford. 55 from home, sits it up towards Gunston. A nervous mark by Frost on the second attempt. They're off here at the moment, the D's, really off.
I really like Tom McDonald as a player. He marks the footy really well, but he does make me nervous when he's kicking it, Roosty. I can imagine
what Roost it would have been intercepts like it, goes inside times. 50. Sorry, Duck. Gunston laid off Frost, and Frost read it best. Took a good pressure-saving mark in defence. Now the ball comes back to the wing. Hardwick, McAvoy gives it to Hartung, paddles it in front of himself, wants to get onto the right boot, does eventually, and he goes back to Frawley, defensive side of the wing, who chips it all the way back for the Hawks.
What's a tackle count, Ash?
24-18, Hawthorn's way.
Teams that have won this week have tackled really well, and perhaps Melbourne to get themselves back into the game. Ruse could apply some real heat as Jayden Hunt arrives late against his opponent, opposing number 29, Langford. Handball, Gibson, Burgoyne waits, dodges and weaves his way through traffic. Ruff's waiting, delivers the ball here nicely to Howe. Burgoyne drifting by, ignores that.
Howe, two kicks from home, drives it tight in the pocket on the right boot, making it difficult. But a really good mark taken by Bruce, who's starting to get dangerous. He plays on, goes short, and finds Smith. Wasn't the distance, so Smith called to play on from 35. Bending ball. Sneaks through for one behind. The Hawks, 5-5-35, Melbourne 1-1-7. Bob Jane, T-Marts, Mickey Roberts.
Jayden Hunt, the dasher, he's off left shoulder in a lot of pain with the doctor and physio right now. Cannot lift that arm above his head. It's real pain for him.
Robbo, go back to the Hawthorn bench, because the medicos have been talking to Grant Birchall too. So look at our man scurry over there. We'll go back down to him very shortly. Robbo, what are you seeing right in front of the race right now?
Hunt going down into the ruins with the left shoulder. Birchall, I reckon his day's done. He's so sore. Also Langford off with a corky.
Yep, our man Robbo does it better than anyone on a Sunday afternoon. All thanks to Bob Jane T-Mart's ball to the outer wing. Pressure from Hawthorn, good. Howe currently kicks it, got an extra 5 or 6 metres down the line, and we'll have it tossed in right half forward flank. 35 playing 7. Hawthorn in control. 2.5 gone. Second term, Triple M Exetel scoreboard.
Turnovers just building and building for Melbourne. Now up to 22.
Lewis, under pressure, gets a hand pass away. Now the Demons drive it long off the boot of Tyson. Hodge, Watts, contested ball. Frawley tracks back to help his former skipper. and eventually gets it across the boundary line. 50 round from the Demons' goal. They trail by 28 points. Only 3 minutes into the second term on the Triple M Exetel scoreboard. Exetel NBN, the speed you need.
Sydney by 54 points over the Lions. Buddy with eight majors.
Here we go. Fremantle and...
Fremantle taking on the Bombers, 440 the main stadium.
Hot conditions over two there, we're led to believe. 29 degrees today in WA. Good tackle, Gullett on a rough head. And we'll have it thrown up. Melbourne, just the one goal, came at the 11-minute mark of the opening term. Pedersen, the only goal scorer. It's been a disappointing start to this one for the Ds. Hawthorn looking to bounce back after a bad loss last week. Jones gets it free to Viney. Hemmed in on the boundary line. A flying shot on goal. It's a starter. A kickstarter from Jack Viney. Terrific finish from the co-captain. He combined with the other co-captain, Nate Jones. And they get a desperately needed second goal. 2-1-13. 5-5-35. Hawthorn lead. Four played. Second term. Triple M Exetel scoreboard.
Yeah, you suspected, Duck, that they were going to have to do something out of pure talent because they're not. They do look a bit off. You mentioned, Swatty, you mentioned tackles. Tackles intent. Tackles about intensity, and they've been out-tackled by Hawthorn. So it's just pure talent that got that goal. Nice forward stoppage. Little handball from Nathan Jones and a fantastic finish by Jack Viney. And hopefully for Simon Goodwin, that will get his team going now.
So Viney with a much-needed goal for the Demons, his second of the season, averaging 21.5 disposals. He's had a good start to the year for McDonald's. Triple M rocks football. Burgoyne spending a bit of time in the middle today. Gives it to Howe, to Billy Hartung, still trying to cement his place in the Hawthorn side. Wobbles one to Sicily, who copped a knock on the shoulder early. Can't take the mark. Smith bends it around the corner. The Demons in defence, working hard through Lewis, but the ball is to be won. Mitchell comes in hard, puts his head over the footy. Clayton Oliver. And the Demons now through Wagner in the middle of the ground. Back to Viney. His leg, the umpire says play on.
Got to get into Bob J. T-Marts. I've got your Tyron Wills covered. Good tackle on Pedersen by Billy Hartung. And so scrappy play, Roosie, but the intent was better around the stoppages.
Better, but that's what Duck was saying before. There's four handballs in that chain. Four players had a chance to kick it.
Yep, overhand ball again to players under pressure.
Mitchell, contested ball king, whips it out of the ruck contest. Pedersen juggling it above his head. Big fist away by the Hawks, trying to get a bit of clear space. They might do that through now. Isaac Smith to Gunston. He goes back to Hodge. Looks to go in ball, but there's no option, so Luke Hodge drives it on the left towards O'Brien. He's had a decent game, kicked the ripper from the boundary line, and it goes across that boundary line in front of Oscar McDonald. 100 round from the Hawks goal. They lead 35-13 on the Triple M Exetel scoreboard.
Come in, Robbo. Animated conversations ongoing with Grant Birchall.
Yeah, unbelievable down here. The fact that he's had a history with the knee as well, coming back from a broken jaw, but they've cut that strapping away. Ice on that now. So you would say if you're going to ice a knee, he's pretty well done for the afternoon.
And Jack Viney getting worked on the Melbourne bench, Robbo. Get on your bike again.
I know. It's all happening down here. And don't forget, you've got a hump with the shoulder as well. Viney's just got a clip. He'll be right. He's pretty courageous.
So we throw it up. Mitchell got a handball off to Shields, but this is better from Melbourne. They need to stop handballing so much and coughing it back. They win possession. Bugs kick is marked by Stratton. Edge of the square. Keen to move it on quickly. Goes to Gibson. Can lay a handball off to Burton. He wraps around Gibson. Puts a high probing speculator. Sicily will fly. Four Melbourne defenders fly. Fortuitously, Oliver got the handball, but then he gives it away.
Hartung goes one way, then the other. Eventually dishes out toward Gunston. Snaps it around the corner from 35. Big goal, Hawks. Second for Gunston. And the Hawks stretch it again. Hawthorn 6-5-41. Melbourne 2-1-13. 28 points, 7 done. Second term. Triple M Exetel scoreboard. Bob Jane T-Marts. All happening, as you said, down there. I don't know if it's Robbo or Bill Laurie.
Birchall, he's got ice wrapped around both sides of the knee. The tracksuit top's going on. He's stiff-legged. He's gone for the afternoon, Birchall.
I'll tell you what, if I'm a small forward of down at Hawthorn, every time the ball goes in, there's about eight Melbourne players flying for the ball. As soon as it comes to the ground, again, there was three Hawthorn players down, four Melbourne players flying. They just got to get that right, the Demons, because at the moment it's completely out of whack.
Well, it's been either too many fly or none fly at all.
So the top three ranked players for Hawthorn, all their ex-premiership stars. Gunston, Bruce, Roughhead combined, 18 touches, four majors.
Langford gets it to half-forward whistle. It'll go Melbourne's way to Hunt. No, it's not. Wagner. Does look a lot like Jaden Hunt. So Wagner in the fluorescent orange boots. Thought about going to the outer side. Comes to the near side. The mark will be taken by Tommy Bug. He's got it right in front of the Melbourne bench. 41 playing 13. Hawthorn lead in control. 8 minute mark, second term. Pedersen on the stretch takes the mark in front of McAvoy.
Pedersen tied on the boundary line. So he chips it inside 50. 5 metres inside the boundary. Big fly from behind by McDonald. Garlett was rushing towards goals but left the footy behind. 2 metres away from the boundary line. Garlett again tries to keep it in. Watts gets around the Burgoyne tackle. Gives it back to Clayton Oliver. Done this well, Melbourne. Now they'll get a kick round the corner, hoping to find someone inside 50. Stratton takes a diving mark. In the end, it spills out. He needs to be careful. The umpire says, no, he didn't have prior opportunity. And it'll be tossed up. 20 out from the Melbourne goals. They trail by 28 points. 9 in to the second term on the Triple M Exetel scoreboard.
14 to go of this second term. Sydney got it done against the opponent at the SCG, Chew.
They did by 54 points with Buddy Franklin nailing 8 goals.
Yep, big day for Bud, and the Swans get their first win. Good juggling mark by Gunston in front of Bug.
So Melbourne still out of whack. 17 handballs, 11 kicks.
And he corrected as a coach, Roosey, in quarter.
Yeah, it's hard. You rely on the players to make the better decisions. They're just making really poor decisions. There's been times where you need to handball, but certainly they've been out the D's and they've handed it to someone who's under pressure.
Aggressive tackle from Oscar McDonald. And he's rewarded. He got Rioli. And then he followed up with a bone-jarring one on Liam Shields and gets the free kick.
The younger McDonald. High ball. A lot of Hawthorn players approaching it inside 50. Stratton could have marked. Elected to go a big 40-metre fist over the boundary on the full. 40 round from the Demons' goal. The Demons trail by 28 points. Gunston has 2 for the Hawks.
So Melbourne in search of their third. Being outplayed by Hawthorn, but they've been their own worst enemy. Duck said a number of times, too many handballs. Errant kicks, Lewis scrubs it underneath the smother. Picked up beautifully by Stratton off to the running man in Billy Hartung. O'Brien's on his bike. Wagner pursues him 10 metres behind him. But he looks up, O'Brien. Chiseling ball, more in hope towards Cyril. Oscar McDonald's got to be good. Got a hand on it. Hartung, good tackle. Watts got to be dropping the ball. Umpire has to be.
Umpire doesn't agree. Says play on. Gee, dropped it like a hot spud though. Now Melbourne trying to reload out of wing. They're under pressure. Nate Jones, little hand pass like they're at training. Almost a drill. Comes back to Hibbert. Now it goes short to Bernie Winstrom Wagner. Melbourne. Jack Watts chips into the middle of the ground to Nate Jones. He immediately looks to the members' wing. Dishes out a long ball to Tom McDonald. Gives one further to Pedersen.
Looks up. Congested forward 50. So Pedersen, more in hope, goes towards Hogan over the top. Good work by Frawley. Third man up, kills the ball out of bounds. We'll have it tossed in 25 around for Melbourne's goal. 13 playing 41, 11 gone. Second term, Triple M Exetel scoreboard. And what are we seeing downstairs, Robbo? Melbourne.
Yes, Jaden Hunt back out doing a fitness test. He grabbed his left shoulder, but he tensed. I think they're doing some sort of fitness test with regards to his legs. So he might have got a heavy knock across there, but he seems to be okay. Got the thumbs up. I reckon you'll see him again.
Burgoyne Hode off his kick, goes out on the full. Oscar McDonald's got it between wing and half forward. Members side for the Demons. They trail by 28 points. He just loads up. They're bombing inside 50 at the moment, the Demons. McAvoy's there in the hole. Gets a fist to Hodge. Careful hand pass by the skipper to Langford. Kicks in Hope. Nearly falls to Roughhead. He needs to get rid of it now. He sits on it like a chicken over an egg. And the umpire said, no, he didn't get a chance to get rid of that.
So I'll have it thrown up. Just forward of the northern wing. 2-1-13 Melbourne trail. Hawthorn 6-5-41. Just repeat for those tuning in for the first time today, Robbo. Birchall, where is he?
Birchall's on the pine in the back seat with the tracksuit on. Right knee, heavily strapped, now iced. He is gone. Could be ligament trouble there.
Viney and Howe were both hard at it. The ball gets prize free. Lewis flicks the handball into the path of the speech to Hannon. Has he got some wheels, this kid? Can he break the tackle of Burgoyne? No. No, it was Gibson in the end. Strong tackle from the veteran. And we'll have it tossed in right half forward flank in front of a sea of pink hats here supporting the Breast Cancer Network. Great to have Raylene Boyle on the program in the preview.
Yeah, indeed it was. She is a wonderful, wonderful lady, Raylene Boyle. A treat to have her in here. Shields goes short to Hardwick.
Oh, there's a blue on. Bernie Vincent, Sicily, Howie, sorry. Scrap it half back.
Stay with the blue. I'll keep an eye on the footy. Anything else happening with the blue?
No.
All right.
fizzled out now.
Wasn't really
bloody
worth
disappointing.
Going to then. Tried to pump it up. It wasn't exactly Tyson Holyfield. Ball goes inside 50, and I reckon the Hawks will get a free kick.
Sicily's going to get a free kick. Been watching it. Bernie Vince hit him high. Sicily does this a bit for a bloke that I wouldn't think would scare too many people. Doesn't mind a bit of push and shove, Sicily. I'm not sure Bernie would be too concerned about him, but Bernie did hit him high. Nothing in it. It's not reportable, but the umpire was watching it, and he paid a free kick.
Some skinny blokes can go, Duck.
I wouldn't be too scared of Sicily, I wouldn't have thought.
All right, the big Duck with his chest out. Not all skinny blokes can go, I must add to that. Now, Frawley slides one down the line to the confrontational Sicily, who could have answered with a contested mark, but Spielder on the third go. Comes back to Bernie Vince, loops a hand pass to Jack Watts, takes off, puts the ball under his arm. Gee, ran a long way, in the end goes short down the line. Chance of Viney to run onto it, he does just that, gives it to Pedersen. Goes a funny little looper inside 50 to no one in particular, and the Hawks have got the answers and the numbers through Gibson.
They are just butchering the ball, Melbourne, butchering it by hand and by foot.
I reckon you just want to get to half-time without too many more scoreboard impacts, Roosy, from a Melbourne point of view, and just get rid of half the first half.
Yeah. Look, they're getting it in. They're 65% of the time the last 10 minutes, but they just haven't been able to score. Pedersen's kick there was terrible. He had Jade Kennedy-Harris in the goal square by himself. But, to Hawthorn's credit, they are putting pressure on Melbourne. So
the pressure is easy for Hawthorn at the moment because the handballs they're giving to people where Hawthorn have numbers, and then Hawthorn just tackle them straight away. So, like you said, it's just really poor decision-making and then, in the end, poor kicking and handballing.
Hartung to the outer wing. Ball eludes Hodge, but it bounces into his waiting arms. He's a great player, so is Ruffett. Gunston delivers to the running man in Smith, the boy from Ballarat. He's got a man forward of the ball. It'll pitch in front of Langford. Can he gather? Yes. Can he get away from Oscar McDonald? He tries. He scrubs the ball along the line. A boundary line bouncing ball. Wonderful goal from Langford. Terrific goal. Had nothing to work with and made it work in the end. 7-5-47, 2-1-13. Hawks can do no wrong. Melbourne can't do anything right. 15 played, second term, Triple M Exetel scoreboard.
And Roosie, we talked about Hawthorn and what their great ability over a long period of time has been, and that's when they dominate a game, they put real scoreboard pressure on.
That's right.
The other thing that they do really well is when they're being dominated, it's like the rope-a-dope. They hold up, they hold up, they hold up. That's exactly what they did. That was their first inside 50s, Howie, for 8 minutes. They go to the other end and kick a goal. They do it, and it kills you.
And it started with a fumble for Jack Viney, too. So Melbourne have certainly shot themselves in the foot. But what you like about Hawthorn today, they look a lot sharper with their skills. They've put some good pressure around the ball. Their tackling's up.
Roosy in the back row, Swatter. It's like we're in the Melbourne coaching box, and he's starting to get a bit frustrated back there as well. Lucky Duck's there to calm him down. That's never been said too many times before. Now, Melbourne receive it out of the middle. Inboard to Geordie Lewis. Marks just inside the square. And Brian patrols the mark. Jordan Lewis, Bosch tool stats.
14 touches, but 17% by foot.
That's a better one. It's a good one to find Tom McDonald. Can he spot someone inside 50? He goes on the left. Real wonky job inside 50. Big mark, though, by Jesse Hogan. First time we've caught him all day. And the big Hogan takes a mark. 25 out, no angle.
Well, that's better. That's better. First time he got to run and jump at it. I'm a bit worried when big Tom McDonald goes on the left because he's not great on his right at times. But what he did is he at least gave Hogan a run and jump at the footy. And that's probably the first time he's got that in this game.
Well, two really nice kicks, Duck.
Yeah.
Hogan, stuttering approach, green boots, loves it. Why wouldn't he? Great to see Jesse Hogan back out there kicking goals. Melbourne 3-1-19, Hawthorn 7-5-47, back to 28 points, 17 done, second term, Triple M Exetel scoreboard.
Yeah, so the first kick, just to explain that, was Jordan Lewis, kicks it a 40-metre, nice spot kick to Tom McDonald. Tom McDonald on the left.
Plays on quickly,
but kick to advantage, Duck. Bombed on the top of the head. And there was a bit of a mismatch. Was it Burton versus...
Hogan.
Yeah, Burton versus Hogan Swatter. So a little bit of a mismatch. So two 40-metre kicks to advantage. And that's the game style, I'm sure, Simon Goodwin. I mean, you've got to handball it at times, but when in space, when you've got time, hit your targets.
So with Hawthorn's kicking efficiency, 77% in the first, only 60 in this quarter.
Yeah, the value of the kick on the 45 on that occasion for Melbourne resulted in a goal. A maul of players on the outer wing. Good tackle. This is better from Melbourne. They lift the appetite. Viney pumps it towards Hogan. Had it, lost it. Burton's there. Hogan with a good tackle. Now Hawthorn had to defend and defend well. Stratton on the wraparound run. Puts the ball to the outer wing. Melbourne have numbers. It's Kennedy Harris. Couldn't take the ball cleanly. Wrapped up. Jones is there along with Vince. And we'll have it thrown up on the southern wing.
It's now about Melbourne taking advantage of this little. They've had 9-8 tackles. Their pressure's up. It's now about them taking advantage of a little period of dominance.
Yeah, they've definitely lifted their intensity. They'd love to get two on the trot. They still trail 47-19. Back row, Wayne Carey, Paul Ruse. CBUS Super Special Comments, award-winning super for the building and construction industry. Outer wing, umpire tosses it up. Melbourne with the numbers, the fall of the ball. Bernie Vince drives it all the way back. It's a good kick. Finds Wagner. And now the Demons through Frost. Press it out towards the boundary line. Hodge. Bug. Well done by Bug. Turns Hodge around. A nice little kick into the path of the Demon speedster who couldn't pick it up was Hunt. And now there's players coming from everywhere.
Ball at half forward for the D's. Frost is involved. It comes free. Oliver. Got a handball to Nate Jones. Was he taken high? Eventually the umpire, slight hesitation. Is that advantage? Goals on its way. It's given advantage. Melbourne get consecutive goals for the first time today. Was hard work. It was scrappy, but they persisted. And they've got consecutive goals. 4-1-25, trailing Hawthorn 7-5-47. Triple M Exetel scoreboard. Exetel NBN, the speed you need.
Well, you don't often say it about Nat Jones, but he was one of the culprits in the first part of this game with his kicking and his efficiency. But, boy, that's a real captain's goal. You can see the grittiness. Just wanted to really force his way through that ball. Got the free kick and then took the advantage himself. He's a great player, Nate Jones. Love watching him play, even though Melbourne haven't had a great deal of success. This man has been an absolute star.
Six games for the season, averaging 28 touches, and he's kicked three goals, now four. And he leads from the front. Tough man, no hair, lots of tats. Not be pretty tough when you look like that, Schwatter, to be honest. Melbourne off half back. They push it forward again. Gibson just puts one hand up, gets over the top of him. You need to be good here under pressure. He is to Hodge. Sweeping hand pass to Billy Hartung. He shorts it to a man waiting in the pocket, popping up like a sprinkler was Frawley, who goes one further to Mitchell and immediately dishes off by hand.
Yep, goes to Hardwick, drives it long down the line towards O'Brien with a good set. Nice hands, got up, good elevation.
He's looked good today.
Yep, the kid wearing the kid's jumper. Hits it long, Burgoyne. Took a nice mark, the veteran. What a wonderful player he's been for so long. And he'll go back and line up for the Hawks' eighth goal.
Jeez, it makes a difference when you can take a contested mark. Mm. And you see there, O'Brien one, and yep, then Burgoyne two. What are the contested marks for teams?
Yeah, Bosch Tool Stats, 8-3, Hawthorn's way. Mm.
So Burgoyne to the punt road end. They lead by 22, have conceded the last two goals to Melbourne. The man who is such a silky football player has possession, pulls the trigger and sprays it to the far side of the high. 48-25, 21 and a half gone to the second term. Hawks lead, Triple M Exetel scoreboard.
Problem for Burgoyne there is they didn't need it enough. He generally kicks the real big goals, doesn't he?
And the end gets a quality centre clearance, doesn't he? The number of times you put him in the middle of the ground.
Oh, yeah.
And, the kick's a good goal, gets the clearance, but...
He is a September operator, possibly not this season, but he is generally.
Oh, there he is again.
There's another contested mark by O'Brien. He shorts it to Mitchell. He showed promise at various times, O'Brien. Had a few games in a row now. Maybe Clarkson's told him, we'll keep putting you in the side. Long ball inside 50. McAvoy just floats across the front of the pack. Takes his second big mark of the afternoon, and he'll go back to kick his second.
Now, Rusey, that time, Bruzy's just sitting here shaking his head because no one flew then. You had McDonald sort of half have a go at it, or was it McDonald? Yeah, it was. It was Oscar McDonald was sort of half in the contest, but just never really did anything. And in the end, does that even count as contested?
Well, it's not a contested mark, surely.
Oh, that's been flagged.
20 out directly in front. McAvoy loves it, gets his second. And the Hawks stretch it again. Hawthorn 8-6-54. Melbourne 4-1-25. Back to 29 points. 22 minutes and 50 seconds gone. Second term, Triple MX still scoreboard. Bob Jane Timas, how busy is this man, Mickey Roberts?
Oh, McAvoy does that a lot, but I just want an update on Birchall. You know, the veteran, premiership player, the whole lot, right knee, heavily strapped, iced up, gone. Could be ligament trouble, could be diabolical, actually. Really disappointed when he came off the ground, but Birchall out for the afternoon.
Well, let's hope it's not as bad as what it may be, Robbo, but good work down there thanks to Bob Jane Timas, his Tyron wheel specialist. Time's that final game get underway, Ash?
It's 4:40, so we're 22 minutes away. Essendon v Fremantle, the main stadium.
Earlier today,
Brisbane were defeated by Sydney by 54 points.
Hawks by 29. Looking to bounce back from a 75-point loss to the rampaging Saints last week. And they continued up that good form St Kilda on Friday night, defeating the Giants. Viney through heavy traffic, releasing the former bomber Hibbard with possession. Bounces the ball to Bug. Got rid of his man Howe. Goes back, gets it again. But good pressure again from the Hawks from Stratton. Hogan got Gibson. Hogan got him really well, and he just laid the ball on the ground. Pet Hayter minding the umpire, said, "I'm not falling for it." Dropping the ball.
And one hand. So it was a great tackle. Hogan dumps it long. Inside 50, players come from everywhere. It's going to spin to the back and it goes across the boundary line 3 metres around from the Demons goal. Chew, you've got to keep us updated on the A-League Grand Final. What time's that kick off?
Yeah, it's at 5.
5 o'clock.
I told you, I had a dream last night that Bessart Berisha kicked a penalty to the victory for a win 1-0 in the 77th minute. I don't know why I recall that.
Well, watch this space.
Strange dream.
Yeah, it was anyway, a strange dream. Yeah. Strange to remember
as well.
The sort
of dream that few of the blokes in the box normally have. But anyway, we appreciate it. Gibson. Handball, now look at rough run and charge and carry and flick the handball over the top.
Some of them don't have to dream about it.
Yeah, I know. And he gets it to Burgoyne. Heads down the line. He's got O'Brien, who's had a bit of it in this quarter.
Yeah, six touches.
Pioppolo's darting back towards the goal square. Going long will be Sicily. Short ball. Not a good kick because Jetta, the man that Roosey rates highly, took an easy mark. Viney, the 1-2 on the charge. Here go the Demons. Better build up.
Oliver explodes off half back. Hodge battling away with Petrarca. What a battle that is. A superstar and a wannabe superstar of the game. Oh, that's an interesting effort by Stratton. Howie didn't get paid for a free kick. Falls to Melbourne. Post. Real low, hard shot from Hannon. Belted straight into the post. Melbourne 26, Hawthorn 54. Triple M, Exetel scoreboard.
He's had to be a free kick to Hannon, didn't it?
He's got some wheels, Roosey, that kid.
Yeah, he looks sharp, doesn't he? He's got some tricks and... He's hard enough too. He's a good tackler, but you're right. I didn't think you were allowed to tackle someone that didn't have the football, but maybe I'm wrong.
28-point lead. Seabus super special comments. Roosey and Duck, good spot.
Oh!
Burgoyne has had that for a half a sphincter second, Roosey, and he's paid the mark.
Half of what second?
Sphincter second.
What's that?
Bugger all!
Right.
Didn't have it long enough for mine. It's what we do on Triple M Howe. If we don't think it's a word, we make it up. Sound convincing. Smith has had a fair bit of it too.
Yeah, Isaac Smith, 12 touches.
High ball to half forward, almost a mark taken. Pioppolo haven't called the ball of muscle's name very often. Nate Jones's tackle on the diminutive Pioppolo was good.
Jones, short, Lewis gets it there just. Bernie Vince, real, real clever little tricky ball. They're going very short, Melbourne. Might be one of the reasons why they're trailing 54-26. They send it down the line. Really good contested mark. Hannon, inboard. It's a bad bounce. They're coming to pieces at the moment, the Demons. And it's going to be a free kick to Hawthorn for one of those below the knees. And Jared Roughhead will get it. They can't take a trick at the moment, the Demons. Hawks need to be careful in defence. Hodge has it. All the way back in the full-back position. Wants a short option. Eventually finds one out of Burgoyne.
2.5 to go the opening half. Hawthorn lead, 54-26. Roosey, you make your way down into the rooms. What's the first thing you say to your old team?
Well, I think it's around the intensity. We've probably seen the tackling of Melbourne pick up in the last 10 minutes. But overall, and then I find that if your intensity's up, your skill level follows. And their skill level's been poor as well. So I'd be concentrating on, boys, we've got to get down and dirty today.
So Salem drills the ball to Tyson, chips the ball to Watts.
Bosch tall stats, only 7 possessions.
He's one player that can really get them back into the game. Jack tries to take on Pioppolo. Handball over the top to Tyson. Chips the ball to Wagner at half forward. 55 from home. Looks up. He's got a sea of players from both teams in front of him. Got one option. Goes towards Petrarca. Provided the contest. Fall of the ball was Bruce. Got a handball away. Nicely done, Howe.
Mitchell sidesteps. Eventually slides it out on the left boot. It's not a good one. Straight to the Demons. They're going to reload. Punch a ball back inside 50. Burton flies late, gets a fist on it. Well done. Well done again by Mitchell. Hodge Very cautious with the handball. Back to Gibson. Goes very, very short. It's okay to Frawley. The umpire says play on. You didn't take the mark chip. So he does play on, does well, evades a player, dumps it out towards Sicily, who takes a good, strong contested mark. They're the ones you talk about, Duck, they relieve pressure.
They sure do. Those ones down the line, if you can mark the footy, generally it opens up. He knows there's not long to go, they'll just go down the line.
So we've got 51 seconds to go, the opening half. Tommy McDonald stood tall. One more before half-time siren would be good for the Demons. Currently trailing at the moment by 28 points. A darting ball to Bernie Vince. Give us the Bosch Tall leading possession winners, Ash.
Hibbard with 17, Oliver 17, Lewis 17. But for the Hawks, Tom Mitchell leads away with 19.
Oh, Cyril's there.
Rioli spills the ball free away from Wagner. Duck caught it. He breaks the tackle. Rioli has one bounce. Goes to Bruce. Did everything right but didn't really find Bruce. Cyril could get it back here. Comes to Puopolo. Rioli from 30 bends it round the corner. Roughhead tries to claim the mark, but it's through for 1 point. You thought when Rioli had it, it'd end up in a goal, but it didn't, Roosie.
You don't often say this, Howie.
But don't say it, Roosie.
Rioli just butchered.
Oh. One behind what, to though, the Hawks.
He might have made a slight mistake by missing the target, but boy, did he turn a 70-30 into a win for the Hawks. You just can't kick it in his area.
Ball's in the air too long.
It was in far too long. He just covers the ground so quickly.
So a big second half for Melbourne to get themselves back into the game because they've been outclassed and outplayed and outscored by the Hawks in the opening half. Hawthorn 8-7-55 leading the Demons 4-2-26 for McDonald. Triple M.
Half time, Triple MCG, Hawthorn 8-7-55, Melbourne 4-2-26. The Hawks by 27 points at quarter time, 29 at the half. Multiple goal kickers. Gunston has two for Hawthorn. McAvoy has two also for the Hawks. All singles for Melbourne. Pedersen, Viney, Hogan and Jones. I turn around and I see Paul Ruse and Ash Chua, the best of friends. I think you finally realised, Rusey, that not having Chewy there in 2005 cost you that premiership. I think you've realised that now and you're trying to make up for lost time.
They actually won in 05.
Oh, I see. Sorry.
2006.
Sorry.
Anthony Carl was very good, but Carly, if you're out there, Chew Man would have been good in the box with you. We went back to back. But no, it's been good, actually. Good discussion. Some really obvious sort of stats, some improvement from Hawthorn first, which will go to Man's tackles, 38 this week compared to...
Yeah, 44 for the entire game last week against the Saints, so those numbers are well up.
Yeah, which is good. I mean, they've never been a great contested ball team. For looking at contested position, they're only minus three, the Hawks. So, I mean, that's manageable. We've seen the Hawks be able to manage maybe a minus 10, minus 15 over the game. Uncontested marks for Hawthorn are up to 46. So, if you're a Hawthorn supporter and you're watching the team play today, listening on the radio, you're seeing the game style that they actually were able to produce in the previous five or six seasons. So that's a real positive. On the other side, if you're a Melbourne supporter, some damning stats for the Demons.
Look, they're butchering it by foot, as you've mentioned yourself, in the Ducks. So they're ranked fifth in the comp for kick efficiency at 68%, but they're going at 61%, but it's the kick clangers that's hurting them, 15-9. And when you roll that out to scores from turnovers, Roosie, Melbourne concede the fourth least number of scores from turnovers at 51 points for an entire game. Well, today they've conceded 7-5-47 and a half to Hawthorn, only at 1-1.
Yeah, and just trying to explain that what Melbourne have done really well in the first 6 weeks is spread the opposition defence. They've been able to use a kicking game, get it out into space, uncontested marks, and beat, I don't want to say conserve, because there's times where they've gone really fast with the ball. They've had a good mix of go fast, go slow. The concern is probably their three best kickers are Bernie Vince. He's had 8 handballs already. Jordan Lewis has had 9 handballs, and Nathan Jones has had 7. So they're combining those three guys, and we're higher than them in particular. Not that they're playing poorly, but Hawthorn are either pressing them into handballing or Melbourne are choosing to overhandball, because at this stage the handball to kick is not great.
131 handballs to 99 kicks. So Melbourne, the most number of handballs they've racked up in the game is 253. So they're on target. But in the second half of that second quarter, their kick-to-handball ratio started to shift. You spoke about Clayton Oliver, I remember, a few weeks ago. He tends to handball a hell of a lot more than kicking. Well, today he's had 17 touches. He's only had 2 kicks to the 15 handballs.
Yeah, look. I'm like everyone else. I'm a massive Clayton Oliver fan. But look, you're going to play your natural game. His natural game is going to be around stoppage and handballing. But yeah, he just needs to correct that a little bit, I believe, because he's actually got good power and speed, so he can get out of traffic and get out of stoppages. So you'd love that to be more around. I don't think it's ever going to get the 50-50. I don't think he's going to be a 10-10 man, but certainly 8-12, which is marginally below that, I think. So 2-15 is probably a little bit too heavily weighted in the handball category. So yeah. The Melbourne picked up their intensity and looked a lot better in that quarter, but yeah, they're just sloppy with their disposal, sloppy with their hands. Whereas Hawthorn, when they get it and they're able to use their kicking and get it on the outside, uncontested possessions, which has been a trademark of their game, they've looked really good.
And Howie, I've got a damning stat for you with the Hawks, and that's positive at the moment, but in second halves,
yes.
Yep. They've won 2 out of 12 quarters. They've been outscored by a combined total of 222 points, so we'll just monitor how they go in the second half.
To be fair, sorry, to say negative. Their first halves haven't been that flash either in season 27.
Better than the second half.
Tim O'Brien, just quickly, he's taken some really strong contested marks. The Hawks are stuck with this young fella for a while. He's starting to look like an AFL player.
Yeah, we talked about the contested marks, Tumi, and that was pretty heavily weighed in Hawks' favour, wasn't it?
10 contested marks they've taken to Melbourne's four. They only averaged 9 in the entire game, the Hawks, are we?
Yeah, and what Hawthorn have done really well is to be able to put it to a dangerous spot at the top of the 10-metre square, and they've either marked it. We've seen McAvoy kick 2 goals from big marks, or they've been able to crumb it. Gunston, Bruce kicking some crumbing goals. So Melbourne need to get that side of the game right. They've either had too many defenders fly, which meant there's a ground ball, or not enough, which means McAvoy's taken some marks forward.
This is the halftime break for IJ Liquor. IJ Liquor, make sure you stock up at IJ Liquor this footy season. Roosie and Chew just waxing magnificently as we get to Mickey Roberts. Robbo, a concern for the Hawks as far as Grant Birchall?
Massive concern in the fact that he's just come into the side off after that broken jaw, but I did mention the fact that he's had a history with knees before. Go back to 2013, he had a right PCL, posterior cruciate ligament, so he was in strife there, and in 2015 medial ligament strife on the knee as well. I reckon he's done a medial ligament here, maybe some cartilage on that right knee. So he knew, Howie, and you picked it up as well, when he came off he slapped his hand and really disappointed. So I reckon he knew exactly what he's done on that outer side, but he was screaming for help to get him off the ground. So right knee iced up. Could be medial ligament with a bit of cartilage, but he's had previous bad luck with posterior and medial ligament before.
Well done, Rob. As you know, I've got tremendous respect for you, but I just need to ask you a question. Were you down on the boundary wearing fingerless gloves?
I was. It's bloody cold. I've swum down the Antarctic before, -39, and that's the coldest I've been for a long, long while down there.
Why not the full glove?
Because you've got to be able to write, mate.
Okay, so he always has an answer, Mickey Roberts. Don't worry about that. Halftime here, Melbourne 4-2-26, Hawthorn 8-7-55. The Hawks lead by 29 points. McDonald's Triple M rocks footy.
Third quarter not far away at the Triple MCG. Hawthorn lead the Demons at the main break, 8-7-55. Melbourne 4-2-26. We'll get the thoughts of the King, Wayne Carey, very shortly on what he thinks will unfold in this third and fourth quarter. But recapping the earlier score, Sydney in a big win. Their first for the season, Tuman at the SCG, and Buddy got a bag.
He certainly did, Swatter. So Sydney 2015-135, defeated Brisbane by 54 points, 12-9-81. Buddy Franklin nailed 8 goals, in fact, 8 goals for, so his highest return since round 21, 2014. And in the final game, Swatter, it's just underway between Fremantle and the Bombers at Domain Stadium. Early stages, first quarter. No score to either side.
Cracker of an afternoon in Perth too, Chu. We're led to believe it's about 29 degrees. Yep. If that could just waft its way over to Victoria, Chu,
nice,
and just warm
it?
Us up, that'd be good. Just going back to the Bosch tool numbers, Buddy had a big day. Some of the prime movers for Sydney have been a bit quiet this year. Give us the numbers for Kennedy, Hanbury, Parker.
All right, so Luke Parker, who's the leading ball winner for the Swans, 30 disposals, 1 goal. Hanbury with 26 possessions and also chipped in with a major. Josh Kennedy, 20 disposals, but also kicked the goal, and were they the three?
Go back to your McDonald's muffin here. It's Hawthorn leading at halftime, Duck, 4-2-26. The D's trailing Hawthorn 8-7-58. But as Robbo said, Grant Birchall is out with a knee injury. That looks to be potentially serious, so fingers crossed for Birch. He's been a great player. But Melbourne, I've worked with you a number of years now. You've made a mention of it in the opening half when Melbourne overused the ball by hand.
they are a completely different side than when they are efficient and clean with their disposals.
Absolutely, and they did it under Roosie's tenure as well. And the one thing I did notice, they did it earlier this year, Swatter. I can't put my finger on which game it was. And they came out after half time and they were able to change it. They corrected it and they ended up winning that particular game. So you can change it. It's one of those things. They're over-handballing. And we spoke about Hawthorn's pressure and the turnovers. Well, that was because of the over-handball of Melbourne putting their players under more pressure than what they're under. Hawthorn then able to put them under pressure, tackle, turnover, Hawthorn go down the other end. Hawthorn dominating the air, certainly with contested marks. So, look, is it fixable? Absolutely. Clearances, Melbourne right on top, 22-12. So really winning in that area. Contested possessions fairly even. So for me, it's just all about Melbourne getting that balance between hand and foot. And obviously their efficiency was a real issue. And going inside 50, Roosie mentioned it a number of times in that first half when Hawthorn kicked the ball in. The Melbourne defenders, they're either all up or none of them are up. So they've got to correct that. And I'm sure they're the little things that Simon Goodwin would have spoken about at half time. And you know what, Swatter?
Yep.
They're all fixable.
No doubt. They are
all fixable with a really good message, strong message at halftime. Come out, refocus. And good teams can fix it within a game, no doubt. And that's what we'll find a little bit about Jordan Lewis and obviously Jones, Viney and these guys. They're the guys that will have to lead it.
Yep. 29-point lead to Hawthorn with the third quarter. Not far away, Demons out in a really tight huddle. Hawthorn just warming up, getting loose, getting ready for the second half. 8-7-55, 4-2-26. I can tell you now, Jim, man, that Sphincter Second has just been nominated to be inducted into the Oxford Dictionary. And out in the media box, there's a couple of people out there think it's a great word. Don't know where it came from.
Now we liked it.
But it just came. And that's what we do, Roosie. We just make sort of stuff up.
That might be in our quiz next week, I reckon.
Yeah, spell it. Good luck.
Spell it.
I'd like to just participate next week, Roosie, because someone took me off the air.
You were very good today.
It's probably the best quiz I've done, right?
Very good.
Melbourne. Duck said the things that they were doing so badly in that opening half are all correctable. Yeah. As a coach who recently coached this group of players, what's your instruction? How do you get them to stop this insatiable appetite of flicking around the handballs, get a man out into space, kick it long?
Yeah, look, you've got to make them aware of it, but you can't overcoach that part of it because often it just comes back to their own decisions. They're still young, so you've got to probably show a little bit of vision at half time and you sort of say, guys, look, this is an area where we could have kicked the ball, because what you don't want to do is suddenly they blast away when there's two or three little handball options on. A lot of it's just going to be their own decisions.
All right, big second half coming up now. Melbourne trail Hawthorn by 29 points for McDonald's. Triple M rocks footy.
There we go. McAvoy gets it down. Burgoyne, Billy Hartung evades a tackle, gives it to Hodge. Steps one way, the other, back to Burgoyne. Silk runs through the middle, puts one inside 50, rough head. Perfect footy from the Hawks. Centre clearance, straight to the big full forward. Rough head marks, 35 out directly in front.
And that's the difference, I think, of having an actual ruckman in the centre bounce. I mean, just easy McAvoy to Hodge. Hodge to, as you called him, Silk Burgoyne. And then just a perfectly weighted kick to Roughhead, who read the flight of the ball way quicker than his opponent, McDonald.
Roughhead should make no mistake from 30 directly in front. Two steps, bang, straight through the middle. Absolutely perfect start. 45 seconds in, the Hawks get the first of the term. Hawthorn 9-7-61, Melbourne 4-2-26 on the Triple M Exetel scoreboard.
Well, it was only 45 seconds because Ruffy took 30 of it to kick it. It was about 10 by the time he marked it.
And I think the other thing, Duck, about that, it's the Melbourne mids have got to recognise that, you know, Pedersen's not as tall as McAvoy.
No,
so it's unlikely that he's going to use his hand on the ball. So they need to have a bit more of a defensive mindset in the centre bounces.
Getting word from deep inside the Hawthorn camp that they don't think Birchall's knee will be too bad, probably the PCL, but the player himself is reasonably positive about it.
Good news. So we'll have it smack down in the middle of the MCG again. 35-point lead to the Hawks. Game high for them. Viney one way, then the other. Slight hesitation. Thought about a handball. Went with the kick. Good hands by Jaden Hunt. Taking a ground.
That's 50.
50
metres.
50
metres.
Has to be.
Against Howe.
Yep.
The mark had been taken. He carried on with the tackle and threw him into the turf. And Clarko just trying to muffle his disappointment.
Yes, what has, and we'll check on it the next, and I'll answer my own question, but has he been moved forward?
He has, and you know what? I like it.
Yeah, Bruce, I
like it.
Yeah.
So Goody's obviously decided, you know what, mix things up.
Yeah.
Threw him up forward, strong mark, good kick from Viney, and he deserved that 50 as well.
Top of the goal square, has to simply kick the goal at the punt road end. Oh, boy, did the umpire have to scurry across. He's just got that through. And an opening goal for the D's. 2.5 minutes play of this third quarter. Melbourne 5-2-32. Hawthorn 9-7-61. Triple M Beaumont Tiles scoreboard.
Yeah, important goal for Melbourne because it nullifies that goal within 15 seconds.
Yeah, absolutely. They had to get that next one, didn't they? But just looking at him on camera, on the Chemist Warehouse replay screen, he looks about 10.
Yeah, well, you should have seen him when he first arrived. I thought he was 10.
This is the man that reported in the paper today. He's got a fascination for owls, Ducko.
Has to see an owl every day.
Well, he feels
where
like
do you see him every day then?
Well, he said it could be fake or real.
Who's that, mate?
There's not too many real ones floating around the middle of the day.
I think he might be a bit.
For McDonald's, Triple M Rocks football. Duck going nicely now on a Sunday afternoon. Melbourne extracted out of the middle. They push it forward again. Spearing ball, Frawley in the right spot at the right time. Takes the intercept mark, gives it to Billy Hartung. He goes one further to Tim O'Brien, who's had a good first half.
Jeez, Hannon's got some serious speed underneath him. O'Brien, a couple of good grabs in that opening half along with Sicily, and he'll come late with a big leap, a slight hesitation. Couldn't take the mark. Ball goes out of bounds, and we'll have it tossed in. 61-32. Goal apiece to start this third quarter. 3.5 gone. On a cold and brisk Melbourne day, Triple MCG. Solid crowd without being spectacular, Ash. Hartung, ball bobbles out of his breadbasket. Viney hit over the nut. Ducking underneath the tackle was Lewis. That was a tackle of Mitchell, I think it was. And we'll have it wrapped up just inside the field of play.
Yeah, Viney started this quarter pretty well. He's had a couple of tackles and he's already had a couple of clearance, two-man, early in this quarter.
He has 10 tackles for the game today.
Yeah.
McAvoy, Pedersen, down to Viney. Slung out of the tackle, gets a hand pass away to Hunt. Petrarca picks it up in the middle. He's immediately beset upon by about four Hawks, which is how many you need to stop him. And he's slung into the ground. Melbourne 32, Hawthorn 61. One goal apiece, rough head early, then Hunt with a quick reply.
Umpire throws it up. Oliver tries to feed a handball to Bernie Vince. Ball goes inside the Hawks forward 50. Tommy McDonald, slight paddle. Getting there, Wagner. McDonald went back and got it, but then it was a pull handball to Hibbard. They dodge a bullet. Wagner fires a handball. Frost, not sure, feeds the handball to Oliver. Back to Frost. It's not convincing, Duck. But they managed to get it out of trouble for the moment. They got a man free. It's Kennedy Harris who can run.
Garlett's on. He doesn't go that way. Spreads it even wider to Hunt, the running man. Takes a good long spell of the ball and drives it home. Hunt's got two in a row. And Melbourne are coming hard at the Hawks at the MCG. Melbourne, 6-2-38. Hawthorn, 9-7-61. Back to 23 points, 5 into the third term. Triple M Beaumont Tiles scoreboard. Beaumont's your one-stop shop for tiles and bathroom wear with over 110 stores Australia-wide.
And a little bit of a PB for Hunt. Two goals. He's been a defender. He's been a defender, but two goals in this term. Good move, Goody.
Yeah, I tell you, isn't speed really important in the game?
Yeah.
Frost was in an enormous amount of trouble down back, but he has got lightning speed. He was able to just slip the jets on and got through, and then all of a sudden Jones with a beautiful handball over the top, and no one was going to catch Jaden Hunt.
Now he's off to the races. Two goals. They trail by 23. 38-61 for McDonald's. Triple M rocks footy. McAvoy gets it moving back. No one there, though. Better appetite for the D. Salem's kick was smothered. Pedersen with a big tackle on Langford. Strong. Pedersen goes again. Oliver puts the head over the nut. They persist. They get it out. Bernie Vince quickly on the boot for Ali. Nice hands in front of Hogan. Better from Melbourne, though. Another couple gets the confidence right up.
Good job down there, Frawley. Goes short to Billy Hartung, number four for the Hawks. Wants someone down the line. Now looks into the middle of the ground. Goes back to his original decision. 60-metre ball, forward of the wing. Big fly from O'Brien. Can't take the mark. Salem hits the ball at speed. Pops out of his arms. Now Bernie Vince has time. He goes for an aggressive kick into the middle of the ground. Howe hits his man really hard. And his man was Hogan. And you'll get a free kick for chopping of the arms. Jesse plays on.
Got it out. Wide, bouncing ball. Kennedy Harris, can he control it? He does. He just tips the ball to Garner. What can Jimmy do? He can wheel around. Pull up the ball. Oh, I think that may have been going for Bug. Getting in the way was Kennedy Harris. But more importantly, Melbourne maintained possession. And Kennedy Harris to go back for their third consecutive goal.
I think a couple of other moves too, Duck. Tom McDonald's resumed his natural position at centre-half-back. Bernie Vince has gone to a half-back flank. So it's a couple of good moves from Simon Goodwin and the match committee on at half-time.
And I like the courage to go back into the corridor to Hogan.
Yep. Kennedy Harris, third game, hasn't kicked a goal so far in any of them. Now would be a good time, kid. High ball. Across the face of goal for a behind. 39-61. D's are coming. 7.5 gone. Third term Triple M Beaumont Tile scoreboard.
Near map aerial imagery around the ground. The final game of round 7.
Yeah, Bombers by 8 points over the Dockers halfway into the first quarter.
Burgoyne. And the plays all round the ground. Tasked here to bring it out from full back. Approaches the member side with a long drop punt. Big fly from behind by Wagner. Gets a good fist to it, but Hartung's awake to that. Now Hodge. Really good hand passing traffic. Rough head. Langford. Late inclusion for O'Meara, who is out of the side again. With a knee issue, but apparently not the knee, according to Brett Ratton. And then Isaac Smith sees it across the boundary line. Just forward of the wing for the Hawks. They lead 61-39 on the Triple M Beaumont Tile scoreboard.
8 gone, third quarter. What are the numbers in this term saying for Melbourne? 2.
Yeah, dominating disposal swatter, 26-15, up in the contested board by +7.
Handballs to kick ratio.
Is 12-14.
Yeah, okay. Jeddah was hit high. The umpire said no. Play on. Petrarca dodges and weaves and dances his way through traffic. This is better. Melbourne through Jones. High ball. Hogan to lock on. A good ball by Harris. Here comes Garland. Thief in the night. There's 3. Melbourne have got their skates on. Simplified the game plan. That's what Duck wanted at half time, and they're delivering. They're back within 16 points. 45-61. 9 played third term. Triple M Beaumont Tile scoreboard.
Well, they're still using that sharp, quick handball. The difference is, though, they're hitting their targets now, and they're giving it to players that are on the move, on the burst. And we talked about speed. All of a sudden, they're making Hawthorn look a little bit slow.
Yeah,
they're moving
the
ball really, really quickly and getting the ball into that forward 50. All that they wanted from Hogan there was a contest. They got it, and Garlett was where he should be, at his feet.
I reckon Nathan Jones was telling you, could have given a little handball to Jay Kennedy Harris, who wasn't in that much better position.
Get it in quickly.
But he got it in and identified a one-on-one, and Jeff Garlett kicked a nice goal off the deck.
What was the lead after Roughhead kicked the opener in the first minute of the quarter, Chu?
Yeah, they got out to a, Howie, to a 35-point lead.
It is all the way back to 16 now. This time the Hawks send it forward to that man, Roughhead. Falls on the ground. Umpire's going to pay a free kick the way of Hawthorn. It'll be to Roughhead. Whether he got one in the back, we'll have a look on the Triple M Chemist Warehouse replay. So Roughhead will have a shot for number 3 from about 35 out directly in front.
Yeah, just having a look.
That's not a free kick.
No.
That's not a free kick.
There's 20 of those a game.
Yeah.
So the big rough. Just 500 not too long ago. He's taking his time. He'll kick from about 38 metres out. Trots in. Good looking kick off the boot. No problems for Jared Roughhead. That's the steadier the Hawks needed. Roughhead's got 3. Melbourne are 45. Hawthorn 10-7, 67. Back out to 22 points. 10.5 gone third term. Triple M Beaumont Tile scoreboard.
I mean, we need to have a look at it again on the Triple M Chemist Warehouse replay, Duck. And again, it's probably better that you go with than me, given I coached Melbourne last year. But there can't be a free kick. It was a marking contest. Ruffy went to ground. All Tommy McDonald did was sort of roll on his side, and he got a free kick against him.
Yeah, no. Looking at the Chemist Warehouse replay screen, Roosey, I concur with your thoughts there. No free kick.
Concurring though, yep, in the back row.
There's a real nice lot of man love going in the back row. Poor old Chew's wedge between the two brothers.
Oh, no, I like it.
See our super special Rudy, comments. Okay. O'Brien into the ruck. Big leap over the top. So is Hodge. Just socks it off the ground. Gets buffeted into the ground. Lewis comes through with some body contact. Viney, he only plays one way, and that's bloody hard at it. Tap the ball into the path of Hibbard. Here goes Bug. Through a heap of traffic. Handball to Viney. Spins out of trouble. Shows Candy. Kept the ball. Drives it long. Demons with courage. Good work by Petrarca. Loose ball. How's there?
Burton gives it across to Frawley. He's absolutely dumped in a tackle. Now the Hawks under pressure in defence. 35 out from their own goal. Melbourne players come from everywhere. No one's getting it clear. Umpire will toss it up. Near map mirror imagery around the grounds.
Around the grounds, we've got the Bombers leading the Dockers by 3 points deep into the first quarter.
Macca's new gourmet creations now available in drive through the fast, easy way to gourmet.
22-point lead. Hawthorn's way. Melbourne forward 50 throw up. Pedersen, Garlett, one-handed. Go to Jeffy, please. Comes to Stratton. Relieving kick round the corner. Hibbard in front. Ball hits the ground into the path of Lewis. Quick hands. Hibbard got some wheels. Gets away from Hartung. Centering ball. Hunt's there. Good hands. Really good set of hands from Hardwick. Or Howe. It's Howe in the end. Strong hands from the kid.
Howe marks at fullback. Favours the members' side. Takes on Garlett. And in the end, as a result, his kick's under pressure. He shanks it to Viney. Good chase on the mark by Garlett, affected the turnover. So Viney, 70 from home. He'll chip it to about 30. Big pack, big fish from behind by the Hawks defenders. Garlett's dangerous, can't get a handle on it. Hodge, clever little hand pass. Howe now under pressure, needs to get rid of it. 30 from home.
They all pile in. Garlett again. This is better work rate from the Demons though, Roosie.
Yeah, absolutely. Viney's been outstanding. 7 disposals, 2 clearances. You touched on it before, Swat. I think he only plays one way, and that's flat out. He's gone to another level, flat out in a bit. Is there another way?
Yeah, absolutely. We've just made it up. Put it in the dictionary, Roosie. So we'll have it thrown up. 30 out from Melbourne's goal. Here comes Salem. Desperate Hawthorn defenders. Mitchell quickly, hurriedly onto the boot. Bounces towards Hibbard. Ruffy comes at him with a good strong tackle. Pyle drives him into the ground. It's a good game of footy. Pressure goes up. Melbourne coming. 45-67. They got it back to 16 points before Ruff kicked his third at the 10.5-minute mark, and we've almost played 14 on the Triple M Beaumont Tiles TikTok.
Really important part of the game at the MCG. Hawks push it forward off the boot, but it's directly out on the full. And that was from Shields. So Melbourne will have it. Birchall, as Robbo told us, out with a knee early in the first quarter. Hibbard, right in front of Robbo. He goes high, really high. Pretty shallow entry inside 50. What a mark by Pedersen. Took on Gibson and Gibson's fist. And that is not easy to beat. And Cam Pedersen will go back to kick his second goal if he's successful from about 48 out.
And that's what he's really capable of, this guy. Got long arms. Put him up and in the end, almost took it uncontested in the end.
62 games, 53 career goals. Already won this afternoon for Pedersen. Walks in, now into a trot. Important kick. Starts it right, stays right. Never looked like it. One behind. Melbourne, 7-4-46. The Hawks, 10-7-67. 14.5 done. Third quarter, Triple M Beaumont Tiles scoreboard.
What are the inside 50s this quarter, Chumi?
Yeah, well weighted in favour of the Demons. 10-3, Bostel. Yeah.
Burton to himself. Goes towards the broadcast half-back flank. Back of the pack. Hibbard getting a stack of it. Ball slews off the side of his boot. And off the hands of Hodge spoiling. Goes out of bounds. Hodge charges to the bench. So does Pedersen. We'll have it thrown in. Alistair Clarkson just saying an animated conversation with his members of his coaching panel inside the box on the Triple M Chemist Warehouse replay screen.
This is when Hawthorn have got a habit of, when they're getting dominated, going to the other end of the ground and getting a goal against the tide.
Puopolo to Hartung. Billy drives it down towards Gunston. He's going to have two to beat. Needs to bring it to ground, and he can't. It's a good mark by McDonald. Immediately dishes by hand. It's cut off, though, by Roughhead. The Hawks haven't got anyone forward of the ball, so Roughhead has to prop and wait and just shanks it into the middle of the ground. Not his best effort. Opens the door for Jack Watts. He's caught in a tackle, though. Now the Hawks try and spot one inside 50. Rioli! Tight on the boundary line. That's where the ball goes. 15 around from the Hawks' goal. They lead 67-46.
16 gone. Third quarter. Around the grounds.
We've got the Bombers leading the Dockers by 9 points deep into the first quarter.
67-46. Hawthorn lead. Roughhead against Watts. Throw in. Pocket. Southern side. Watts completely missed it. Frost. Good tackle on him by Mitchell. Salem's there. So is Burgoyne. Oliver. Another handball. It was partly intercepted. Tyson over the top. We'll have it thrown up 40 out from the Hawks' goal.
What's the world record handballs for a player? Kick handball. Oliver's had 2 kicks and 20 handballs.
Might have been Peter Featherby back in 81. And I'll come back to you.
That's a Bosch tool stat from quite some time ago. Rioli. Hands and knees. Big tackle applied by the Hawks attackers. They keep it inside 50.
Howie Viney, number one ranked player on the ground. 21 disposals, but thrown 11 tackles. He's had 11 physical pressure acts, which is the most on the ground.
Hawks by 21. Throw up, 40 out from their goal. Oliver, that was a kick. It was smothered. That's maybe why he handballs. Frost, the fend off from Smith. Got it to Nate Jones. Half back. Heads down the line. Hogan. Howe comes through. Third man up. Kills the ball out of bounds. Southern wing. Throw in.
Earlier on today.
Sydney too good for the Lions by 54 points. Buddy Franklin, 8 majors.
Near map aerial imagery around the grounds in the west.
Bombers by 15 points over Frio. Deep into the first quarter.
And Victory and Sydney FC kick off shortly. Chew will be across that one. Got all sports covered. Pull up below. Little legs pumping. Gives it to Langford. Little sly ball on the right boot finds Burgoyne. He puts it right to the top of the goals. In fact, Sean Burgoyne, have a look at that, from tight on the boundary, just goes bang. An incredible goal from Burgoyne, and needed to steady the ship for the Hawks. Melbourne 7-4-46, Hawthorn 11-7-73. Triple M Beaumont Tiles scoreboard. Was it a pass or a shot?
I'll give him the benefit of the doubt. He's such a good player. I'm not going to argue with him. What you said before, Duck's right. I think they've had 5 inside 50s for 3 goals this quarter. So they're getting dominated in that area, but they've had the ability out of 5 entries, 3 goals.
3 goals each in this third quarter. They've restored order. After Gallagher got his first, it was back to 16 points, but goals to Roughhead, which was his third, and then Burgoyne. Margin back out to 27 on the Triple M Beaumont Tiles scoreboard.
A bit testy, a man in the back row. I haven't seen it before from Roosie.
Well, he's got to...
I'd be more testy if I was sitting in the coach's box.
If it continues to go pear-shaped, how's he going to front up when he's got to give out the not-so-goods?
I don't know.
For McDonald's, Triple M Rocks Football. We're not kidding, Roosie. You can laugh as much as you want. You've got to step up and deliver them today. Vernie Vince, hurriedly on the boot. Good work by Hardwick. The kid took the mark. Centre half back. Squares it out wide to Gibson. Bouncing ball. Got time to gather, though.
Gibson winds it back to Burton. Needs to be careful. Gives it back to Gibson. He's under pressure. He's gone, Josh Gibson. Really good defensive work by the Demons. I think it was Hannon that applied the tackle. It was. And if he wishes, he can have a shot. Hannon from 40.
I don't like players playing on an advantage, but if Hunt had a bit more, not awareness, but if he knew, he could have picked that up and almost run into an open goal. But he was 30 metres out, so you give him the benefit of the doubt.
He's a bit unlucky there, Gibbo. He had Hunt and Hannon, both speedsters bearing down on him.
Kicked 6 goals this season, Mitch Hannon. On the left, it's a bit wobbly. It'll go to the top of the goal square. Mark need to be taken. Punched away by Hawthorn players, tight on the boundary. It goes across there, 3 metres around from the Demons' goals. Normally when you turn around to listen to your special comments, he's got a big smile on his face, he's happy, he's cheery, but you look at him now and he's got a face of thunder.
And I think the phone's going nuts because one of his two sons is sending him text messages. No, not happy with the performance.
No, they're happy with me today because I won the quiz.
Buck back of the pack, kick goes nowhere, just straight up in the air. Big sea of players. McAvoy over the top with a big clearing spoil. Bernie Vince, he'll mop up. Feeds the handball back to Nate Jones. Just puts it in reverse before he goes onto the left shoe. Hogan, no, it's Pedersen. Wedged between a couple of Hawks. Here's another former Hawk. Lewis on the right shoe. Kicks a goal. He'll enjoy that one, Geordie. He's been to the world 4 times with his former teammates. And now he's an integral member of the Melbourne outfit. And he kicks an important goal. 8-4-52. Hawthorn 11-7-73. 20 and a half gone third term. Triple M Beaumont Tiles scoreboard.
I'll tell you who was fantastic then was Cam Pedersen, Duck. He had 3 Hawthorn players. One was trying to block him. One was behind and one was in front. And he was able to bring the ball to ground.
Just so important. And that's... And Ruzzi, you talk about big forwards and, you know, some of them take a little longer to mature, but you don't expect them to take a lot of marks. And I know Pedersen is not in that category, but it's an example of, you know, it doesn't matter if they take 10 marks, you just don't want them to get outmarked. Yep. You just want them to compete. That's exactly what Pedersen did there.
You know, wonky donkey bounce, so the umpire will recall it. Near map aerial imagery, how the Bomb Rays going?
They're going all right, Howie. They're up by 14 points over the Dockers nearing quarter time.
Had a lot of changes, didn't they, in the Bombers? To take on the side in the west. McAvoy, perfect ruck work to Burgoyne. Hawthorn have been efficient inside 50 this term. Will they get another opportunity? They're about 30 out from their attacking goal, the Hawks. Players arrive late. Puopolo, I haven't called his name a great deal.
You just took the words right out of my mouth.
I wish that you were the Poppy.
I haven't. What are his stats?
Yeah, he's had 8 handballs, hasn't had a kick today and scoreless.
I think Eddie sounded better than Duckman.
I'm not sure we need to worry about Poppy's stats.
Not. Clearing ball. Broadcast wing. Hawks collide, Stratton on the charge, Pedersen looped a handball over the top, wasn't a good one, getting in the way, Gibson, he's under heat, Hogan, he's going with Frawley, Hodge is there, here comes Haddon, got rid of Hodge, they lift the rating again, Melbourne, they get it free to the former Hawk, Lewis, handball, Viney been outstanding in this quarter, Pedersen's got to go with Stratton.
Stratton goes a big punch, goes directly up in the air, now Burton, he's in the van, McAvoy brought to ground. Had the footy, Mitchell has no one to hand pass to, so just goes wide into the middle of the ground. They're still coming here, the Demons. Jones splits it out to Petrarca. They got options inside 50. He boots it all the way to the top of the square. Really good defensive effort there by the Hawks. I reckon it was Hardwick with a goal-saving fist, and it's an important behind.
It was a great kick by Petrarca. I know Bug's got his hands up saying, what about me?
Don't sing it, Doug.
No.
It isn't fair.
But it was a great kick to the goal square.
Singing 20 point lead.
He doesn't get paid anymore for singing it, Howie. Just keep it real. Petrarca pumps the ball inside 50. Tyson. No, it was Hogan. Had a good piece of it. 45 out from Melbourne's goal. One more. They're back within striking range. They keep it free. Lewis to Jones. Feeds it back to Watts. Chipping ball. More in hope. Goes to Frost. Got up high. Full of the ball. Salem.
Caught in a tackle. Dishes it out. Hardwick. Cop one high. Umpire says play on. Somehow the Hawks bang it out of 50. Right. I reckon we'll be on there in a hurry. Puopolo, McDonald. Puopolo grabs his arm. But somehow McDonald had got rid of the footy. He's holding the ball.
He's got the free kick.
No, in fact, it's holding the man.
Yep. Yeah.
It was holding his arm.
The ball, didn't he?
I thought so, Rusey.
Yeah.
So it goes back to Hibbard.
Strange.
Maybe Melbourne. Not had control of it, the umpire thought. He had McDonald by the arm.
Into the middle of the ground, Melbourne. They're coming and they're coming hard. Salem, really short ball. He's good. Finds Hunt. He's already kicked two this term. Jaden. Loves an owl. Pops it inside 50. Rough head Hogan! Oh, the big Hulk! And Duck enjoyed that in the back row. Hogan marks about 15 out on a 45-degree angle. Must kick it.
Well, he's been close a few times today, taking some big ones. Had a good jump at it, but he gets a good, clean run at that one. Over Ruffy as well, with Gibson coming in third man up. That's a really strong mark, and that's why people get so excited about this guy, because he can do that.
To get it back to 14 points, plays on, goes round the corner and kicks the goal. Interesting approach, started as a drop punt, ended up as a Stevie J round the body. End result, 6 points, that's all that counts. Melbourne 9-5-59, Hawthorn 11-7-73, back to 14 points after it was 29 at the half. 24 and a half into the third quarter, Triple M Beaumont's our scoreboard.
Yeah, I mean, they've really dominated the quarter. About 80 disposals to 45, Chew. They've inside 50, yep. 15 to 6. So they're starting to get some results, and that's a terrific mark. You mentioned before, Duck, the value of a contested mark. Hawthorn have done a great job blocking up their defence, and it hasn't been really easy for Hogan, but you love it. Pedersen brought the last one to ground. Garlic kicked the goal. Hogan flies, takes a mark. So their bigs are starting to get a bit of reward now.
Seabus Super Special comments. The King and the Zen Master. Here's the other member of our team downstairs, Robbo Bob Jane T-Marks.
Yeah, Pedersen off the ground. Doctor gave him a concussion test. Heavy hit at centre-half forward. Got the thumbs up.
14-point lead. Robbo got to go because Viney's on the charge. He pumps the ball. Hogan one out with his man, Jesse. Oh, he had it. But he was really good, Burton. Did really well under some serious heat.
McAvoy arrives late in the scene, takes a good mark. All of a sudden, hard to see where the Hawthorn goals are coming from. Melbourne have kicked 5-3 to the turn. They trail by 27 at quarter time, 29 at the half. It is back to 14 points with 4.5 on the clock before three quarter time. Big fly out of side. There's a free kick. Jack Watts giving away one in the back to McAvoy. And McAvoy trots back off the mark. He goes short all the way back to Howe.
And just look at the way they're willing to work up and keep that forward pressure on Melbourne, Roosie.
Yeah, they're taking away the uncontested marks this quarter.
Smith, he's gone quiet in the game, Ash.
Spot on, spot on. Only one possession this quarter.
So he's got it. You get a gentle shepherd from McAvoy. And Smith, the boy from Ballarat, drives the long ball down the line. A good mark by O'Brien. It's a one-on-one contest. Roughhead's long. Gives him an opportunity with Frost. Frost did really well. Fall of the ball. Frost did exceptionally well. Doesn't muck around. Charged onto the loose ball. Got a handle on Evgeta. And now the D's go. And go through Salem. And Kennedy Harris. And Tyson.
Tyson. Left foot ball to Nate Jones. They've got all the run, the D's. He's got options inside 50. Swings around. Wants to get on the right. Now on the left. Chips it. Deep ball. Garlett from behind. Hogan can't take the mark. Important fall of the ball. Tyson gives it to Bug. Could out a shot. Went a real little interesting short pass. And arriving late on the scene with a two-fisted spoil is O'Brien away from Hannon through for one behind. Hawthorn 73, Melbourne 60.
Well, they did really, really well there, the Hawks, because Melbourne had numbers everywhere. So the Hawks just able to cover. That was a certain goal. So well done to the Hawks' defence.
Like the Hawks have let the emergency parachute out at the moment. They've got nothing in the legs. Hogan, the good spoil, right in front of the D's bench. Flicks the handle over the top. Got Tyson starting to get a bit of it. Wants someone to come at him. Heads down the line. Goes towards Hunt. Engages. Good spoil, Hodge. Been around a long time, the boy from Colac. Didn't fall for that one. Killed the contest. We'll have it thrown in. 35 around from Melbourne's goal. They trail by 13. One more and the D's fans bathed in pink will go nuts.
Ball back into play. O'Brien and Watts. Demons doing everything they can to get it under single figures before the three-quarter time break. As Petrarca sends it across the boundary line, 10 Rafferty's goals. What do the Hawks need to do, Roosie?
Well, this has been the problem for the Hawks. We talked about it at half-time. Their uncontested marks have gone from 46 to 10. It's just they can't sustain this style of game. And when you're not consistently winning contested possession, it becomes really difficult.
Scrubby ball eludes Wagner. Fortuitously into the waiting arms of Gunston. Centres the ball to Smith. Got a vacant centre square. One, two, three bounces. Oh, he bobbled the mark. Then a bad bounce. Good enough to go back and get it. Chipping ball around the corner. Sicily charging through Frost. Committed himself to the contest and saved the day.
Really good work by Frost in the Melbourne defence. Sicily couldn't quite bring the mark down from there. It would have been a certain goal. The Hawks, in soccer style, are on the counter-attack.
I'll tell you what, guys.
Free kick downfield against Sicily.
Sorry, Howard. Frost's last two efforts have been unbelievable. Yeah. He covered two Hawthorn forwards then.
Here they go again,
Roosie.
Got to jump in there. Watts, beautiful tap. Got it to Hogan. They're building. They're believing. They're thinking they can win this one. Gala takes the mark. 15 out. Slight angle. And Melbourne to get back within 7 points.
Yeah, take a bow, Sam Frost. His last 5 minutes have been unbelievable.
It was massive, wasn't it? Yep. And that was a crucial down the field free kick. Yeah. But tell you what you don't do when little Jeffy gets the ball. Don't run into the goal square and call for the footy because he'll try to give it to you.
For three in a row. Here come the red and the blue. Melbourne back within 7 points. 10-6, 66, 11-7, 73. Almost 30 minutes played to the third term on the Triple M Beaumont Tiles scoreboard.
Actually, Roosie, I'll ask you. That's a good example. As a coach, do you tell... So Jeffy takes that mark, 30, our slide angle, should just go back and kick it.
Yep.
You always turn around, because if it's on, if it's definitely on, you give it, right? But if it's not on, it's only half on, you don't encourage the guy to even run there. To put it into his mind to give it.
Because, Jeff, I mean, most players want to do the team thing. If your teammate's screaming at you, it puts an enormous amount of pressure.
It does.
So don't run in there.
Exactly.
Don't run in. You're better to go up and say, Jeffy, we need this one.
Spot on.
Yeah.
Hugo.
Yeah, just with the Hawks. They've now conceded 149 points in third quarters.
Triple M Chemist Warehouse replay screen. Jeffy Garlett making Stratton look at the replay of him kicking the goal. Cirioli from nothing. Approaches 50, goes to Roughhead. Can't take the mark.
Frost,
he's having the best 5 minutes of his career at the moment. Roughhead looks set to mark 20 out from a Rioli pass. And Frost arrived from nowhere. And now the Demons again can reload through Wagner.
Wagner spears the ball. It's a hot one for Frawley. Pedersen comes at him on the outer wing. Hartung releases the handball to Hardwick. Frost again was outstanding.
Tell you what, how cool has Frost been?
Yep. Oh no. He's the singing Iceman is our man. Laughs at his own jokes. May figure in the not-so-goods later on, Roosie. Think about it, Roosie. Give him the whole bloody seven of them. six. In fact, Gunston's got the ball on the outer half. They lead by seven, Hawthorn, but faltering.
I can't work under these conditions. Gunston drives the ball, 30 from home. O'Brien, big fly, can't take the mark. Mitchell, but he's beaten by Viney. Melbourne, they've got the answers at the moment. Outer side of the ground, short chipping ball. Here he is, the speedster Hunt takes off immediately. Looping hand pass out in front of Hannon. Tries to bring it to heel, does now. Inside 50, Salem could have been in pinch. Humboy says play on, doesn't matter, because Garland's kicked another one. It doesn't matter, Roosey. Jeffy's got three. Melbourne are within a point. And now Roosey's got a real big smile on his face.
Can we, Sam Frost, unbelievable 5 minutes. It's been a young career, but I tell you what, he has saved three goals. It's been a, and it's L two ground two goal swing, so it's a six goal swing, Sam Frost. And I'm not sure how an umpire can miss that free kick. He's standing 5 metres away, just as well Jeff Garlett kicked that goal.
Yep.
But the speed of ball movement, what we're starting to see now, Duck, is that talent of Melbourne. They're young and they're inconsistent, but you can see when they're playing well how much talent they've got.
Just the, got the wheels.
And the speed of Frost, just to be able to close down on Roughhead. Yeah. Was
1 point ball game, 18 seconds to go. Melbourne have kicked four consecutive goals and seven of the last nine. We'll have it thrown up, remembering that when Roughhead kicked his second at the 47-second mark of the third quarter, Hawthorn led by 35 points. They've conceded 34 now. Garlett's got three, and he's given a gobful to Stratton. 8 seconds to go. Can they get another one and get the lead? It's been a wonderful third quarter response. Umpire charges in. 4 seconds on the clock. Got a big fourth quarter coming up, and the Hawks need to get some fuel back in the tank.
Triple M Chemist Warehouse. Ruffy pointed to Stratton as the three-quarter time siren sounds after his second goal and said, look at the scoreboard after his third. He was holding up three fingers to him. I kid you not, big quarter by the Demons. They turned it around. They were 35 points down at one stage. Now they just trail by 1 point. Hawthorn 11-7-73. The Hawks haven't had good second half all season, Chewy.
Outscored by 150-plus points. So that was Melbourne's best third quarter against the Hawks since 1966, Howie.
Hawthorn 73, Melbourne 72. Triple M Beaumont Tire scoreboard. That is it. 1 quarter to go. McDonald's, Triple M, rocks down the Arvo footy. Melbourne got out to a 35-point deficit in the third term. Then Jeffy Garlett lit the whole show up with 3 goals for the term. Melbourne 11-6-72, Hawthorn 11-7-73. The Hawks by just 1 point. Bob Jane, T-Mart's best tie price guarantee, Robbo.
Howie, as you can notice, Grant Birchall walking off with his teammates. Compression bandage on that right knee. The whisper is it could be his PCL. He did that back in 2013. He's got a big history on that. And he sort of knew exactly what was going on when he actually did it in the first quarter. So don't be surprised if you're on the money with the PCL, but that's really unfortunate for the veteran.
Yeah, dominant quarter by Melbourne there. They're in front, 21 contested possession. They've got in front of the tackle count as well. Some really good positional change at halftime. Hunt the half forward, kicked 2 goals. Tommy McDonald back to his normal spot at centre half back was really important. Vince back to half back flank. I thought Dom Tyson, Nathan Jones and Jack Viney were outstanding in the middle of that quarter.
Around the grounds, Swatter. Bombers by 8 points over the Dockers, early stage of second quarter.
Pedersen's been good too, Roosie.
Yep, absolutely.
And he'll line up against big boy McAvoy. It's a 1 point lead, but Hawthorn are really shaky. And the D's showed them up for a total lack of leg speed in that third quarter. 7 goals, 4 to 3 straight. They got the D's. They are definitely within striking distance of their fourth win for McDonald's. Triple M rocks footy. Pedersen goes early. McAvoy down to Burgoyne. Arcs around. Hoicks a high ball in the direction of his forward 50. Four Demons go up. Loose ball. Puopolo. They've done that a bit today. Gunston Hamble over the top to O'Brien. And inside the first 16 seconds, there's the Hawks goal. Where's the communication, Melbourne defenders? 7 point margin, 79-72. O'Brien's got two on the Triple M Exotel scoreboard.
Well, that's what this Hawthorn team does at times when they're being challenged. They have an ability to just kick a goal against the tide. And boy, did they need that. Now it's up to Melbourne. Let's see how they respond.
Yeah, absolutely. But another one of those, you called it. There was four Melbourne Demons players up for that mark. And when the ball hit the ground, it was just a free-for-all for Hawthorn. So their lack of communication the whole day has really been a problem forward at centre.
Burgoyne with the centre clearance. He's in there alongside Rioli, Mitchell and McAvoy. McDonald's, Macca's, Gourmet Creations. What's Melbourne now got? Well done by Oliver. To Vince, pushes it forward. Hodge, though, running back with the flight. Takes a good mark. Just steadying things back. And down at centre-half back, Lou Hodge. Goes really short to the middle of the ground to Mitchell. Triple M Bosch Tool Stats, leading possession winner for the Hawks this season.
Yeah, he's racked up 25, coming up at 38% by foot.
Mitchell, carefully, out wide. Frawley takes the mark at half-back, southern side, City End. 7-point lead to the Hawks. Just the one win so far from six games. He shorts the ball, but too much carry on it. Bouncing ball, Jetta, through traffic. Quickly handball, they flick it around. Vernie Vince got it off to Tommy McDonald. Kick was touched. Mitchell gets in the way. Loose ball kept alive by Tyson on the southern wing.
Somehow managed to stay in. Hacked off the ground. The way of Melbourne, but it comes back towards Frawley. He just goes an upcountry punt down the wing. Big fly from behind by McDonald. That's Oscar. Can't take the mark. Really nice hand pass by McAvoy to Burgoyne. Danger for the Demons if Burgoyne can spot someone inside 50. Plays on, goes a hand pass right to the top of the square. Really good spoil though on the kick from Puopolo. Lewis is involved, but a force to Rioli. Back to Puopolo. Can't get away from the Jetta tackle. I think he's in trouble here, Poppy. Players come everywhere. Eventually spills out. Now McDonald, it's Oscar, Clayton Oliver, and the Demons have got a little bit of space on the halfback flank.
Oliver doesn't want to kick it, so lays a handball off to Viney. Burgoyne got him late, but fair, but enough pressure to force the kicking over. And Stratton takes the mark on the southern wing logo. 79-72, round the grounds.
Bombers leading the Dockers by 14 points. Make that 15 halfway into the second.
Hawks keep it alive across halfback. Come towards Burton on the stretch. Takes the mark right in front of the Hawks bench. Birchall off and out of the game in that second turn. Shields for Bosch Tools.
Bosch Tools stats. Shields only 10 possessions.
Pup Shields. Plays on, right foot ball, 30 from home. McAvoy gets front position, and it was O'Brien that spoiled him, and that's not the way you want to go because he's on his team. Rioli tries to get through four tackles, manages to get through three, not the fourth. Now, ball to be won, and it's won by the Demons. They just hack it out of their defensive zone. Important contest in the middle of the ground.
Nate Jones will come at it, but he lets it go for Hogan. Good tackle on him by Mitchell. Hogan went again. Couldn't find a handball target. Gibson dispossessed. It's a hot ball. Jones hands and knees. Gets it out towards Pedersen. Good handball. Watts wants a target. Waiting. Gave one off to Tyson. All in the confines of a 10-metre space. Lewis loops the handball back. Jetta got some room, got some time, and got some support.
The Demons by hand. Tom McDonald, middle of the ground, bit of room, spreads it out of side to the quick running Hunt, takes a really good mark on the stretch in front of Stratton, plays on immediately, bangs it inside 50, Jetta, Smith, umpire says play on, well done by Isaac Smith, now Hodge is in trouble, how did he get rid of it? Incorrectly, Luke Hodge is done for holding the ball, and the Demons will get a shot, 20 out directly in front by the man that applied the tackle, and that's Jack Watts. Had a couple of goes, Hodge.
Well, thought they might have been overusing the footy in that off half back, but then in the end, really good. The difference was, if you're going to use the handball, at least give it to a player not under as much pressure and then execute the skill correctly. And that's what they were able to do on that occasion, Melbourne. Got the ball inside 50 and then good pressure from Watts.
Should convert for his 13th goal of the season, Jack Watts, to get it back to 1 point. Three little steps, chips it through. And Melbourne answer, one goal apiece in the final term. Melbourne 11-6-78, Hawthorn 12-7-79, 1 point margin on a cold afternoon at the MCG on the Triple M Exetel scoreboard. Exetel NBN, the speed you need.
Yeah, it's a good point, Duck. There's a difference between handballing 3 metres and one that Jordan Lewis hit off the back. It went to probably 15 metres out into space, which then allowed the next player to kick at the Oscar McDonald, who then gave it to Tom McDonald, who then able to kick it. So it's not just necessarily the handball numbers, when and where you're handballing it. A wide handball out of space gets you into a kicking game.
CBUS Super Special Comments, Paul Ruse, Wayne Carey, award-winning super for the building and construction industry. Margin 1 point, Hawthorn's way. Melbourne have been good after the halftime break. 29, 27-point lead at quarter time. Hawthorn 29 at the main change. 1 point at three-quarter time, and that's the margin right now. 5.5, almost 6 gone. Final term. Ball at half forward for the Hawks. Umpire puts the P away. Oliver got it free. Slams it on the boot up towards Garland. He's spoiled well by Stratton. Coming hard at Stratton again was Bug. Kept it alive and kept his feet. That was important. Watts spins out of trouble, then back into trouble. Bug gets it back.
Melbourne battling away in the middle of the ground. Well done by Oliver. There's a free kick being paid too high.
Luke, release.
And that's
straight
against
back.
Luke Hodge, who doesn't want to let Clayton Oliver go. A couple of tough nuts.
He's got him in a sleeper hold, Hodgie.
I tell you what, if Melbourne get in front, they might be hard to rein in. The Hawks just hanging on by a point. Early stages, final term. Oliver plays on, feigned a hand pass. Now dumps it long towards the big Melbourne forwards at the back. Hunch dangerous if he can get a hand on it. He does, avoids the Hardwick tackle. Now back to Garlett. Kennedy Harris snapping. High ball. Mark need to be taken. Umpire said it's not far enough. Ball spills to ground. 20 out from the D's defensive goal.
Loose ball comes into the path of Wagner. The pick up, the kick was equally good, but goes towards the pocket. Hunt's there. Good ball, Frawley. Had to kill the contest. They're really wobbly now, the Hawks. They lead by a point. Melbourne have it in their forward 50. Deep in the pocket. 7 played. Final term. Triple M Exatel scoreboard.
Momentum all with Melbourne at the moment. Someone's going to have to stand up to really stop it for the Hawks. Ball going nowhere.
This is where you want to be on the move, Ruzzi. As a small forward, you want to create confusion for your defenders, for the Hawthorn defenders. So you don't want to be flat-footed. You know that McAvoy's probably going to win the tap out, but be on the move.
Jones, Pedersen, Howe, Smith, his hand pass. He is quickly pushed across the boundary line from Nate Jones. Melbourne 78, Hawthorn 79.
And this is where it is so much harder, Ruzzi, for that third man up. This is where the third man up can generally come over and tap it back into space and, you know, you can really be on the move. A lot harder now that that's not a part of it.
Nate Jones, was he taken high? I think he may have been. Non-officiating umpire near the edge of the square. Saw the contact so the co-captain could go back and put the Demons in front.
Now, Ruzzi, you know him. Will he have a drop punt? His right footer, or will he run around on his right foot?
He's generally a drop punter.
Is he?
Yeah.
So he's got one. Have they led at all today, Ash?
No, they haven't, Swatter.
Thank you, Chew Man, for Bosch Tools. 8:15 gone. The way he's holding the ball, it's going to be a drop punt. We ride right behind the co-captain.
Ruzzi knows his men.
Half forward, tight angle, on its way. It hits the post high up or behind. We're all square. 79 points apiece, 8.5 gone, final term, Triple M Exatel scoreboard.
Yeah, contested possession since halftime. Boys, 64 to Melbourne, 38 to Hawthorn.
Gee, near map aerial imagery around the grounds to the west.
Bombers by 21 points over the Dockers, halfway into the second quarter.
Hardwick, out of back pocket for the Hawks, no one on the mark, so he plays on, runs his full measure. Bombs it down towards Sicily, being quiet, but there takes a good contested mark. He can do that. He chips it inboard to Smith. One of the Hawks got in answer. Really struggled in the second half of games this season. He goes back to Langford.
Yep, defensive side of the southern wing. Just a goal apiece in this quarter. And it's locked away, 79 points apiece. Langford heads long down the line. Can the Hawks get a mark? They can, in the form of a towering Ruffy. Got three Ruffy. Has it a kick and a half from home. Off a step. High ball, McAvoy to come at the ball. Good work by McDonald. Oscar floated in, third man up, and kills the ball. Throwing 30 around from Hawthorn's goal.
Probably kept them in the game a bit. Contested marks, Chew. What's that for the game?
Yeah, Hawthorn 17 to Melbourne 8. Hawthorn only averaging 9 for an entire game this year.
McAvoy, Pedersen doing the ruck duel. Bruce attacks the footy hard. That's what Duck said. You want your small forwards hitting it at speed. 20 out from the Hawks goal. Melbourne running back. Jenner's in big trouble. Puopolo's nailed him. Umpire says. Across the boundary line. We'll toss it back in. All square.
That's that confusion that we talk about with the holding the ball decision.
Yep.
You know, 1 week that'll be holding the ball. And today it's not. I think that's holding the ball. I think that was a perfect tackle by Poppy.
Bruce rides the bump. Handball off the shields. They've done that before. Kick across the face of goal. It breaks the deadlock. 1 point. Hawthorn lead. 80-79. 10.5 play. Triple M Boma, Triple M Exatel scoreboard.
79. Melbourne. 80 the Hawks. Bernie Vince, ball in hand. Goes short to himself. drives it along the defensive side of the members wing. Gibson, that fist we've seen so many times. Viney's aware of it though. Rose, now Bug. The Demons with the momentum, but the Hawks with a 1-point lead. Hunt works his man Burton under the ball and then punches it in front of himself. Burton tracks it back. Got to be careful. Hunt's on his hammer. Does well under pressure. Gives it back to Hardwick. Kick needs to be good and is to Smith.
Yeah, it was really good. Under real heat, Hawthorn. Hanging on to a slender 1-point lead. 12 minutes of the fourth quarter to go. Smith down the line. O'Brien hit hard. Collides with Wagner, I think it is. Bruised on the charge. Delivers nicely to Roughhead. And the Demons have a player down not far from their bench. Robbo's Roughhead lines up for goal number four. And it's Wagner.
He's down all right. Hasn't moved. He's half back. Physio doctor out to him now. So in a lot of pain. Just see whether he's just getting to his feet now, Swatter.
Yeah, we just saw the replay. Collision with O'Brien on the Triple M Chemist Warehouse replay screen. Chemist Warehouse for Mother's Day fragrances. Roughhead on the runway for four. And a steadier. And the skipper nails a goal. Hawks have a little bit of breathing room. 13-8-86 to the Demons, 12-7-79. 12 gone. Final term, Triple M Exetel scoreboard.
Yeah, certainly when the ball's in the air, Duck, that's when Hawthorn have looked the most dangerous. The contested marks, we saw a contested, not a mark there, but came to ground. And every time, Melbourne just can't seem to get that area of the game right at the moment. There's either got no one going up or too many going up. And that was Bruce crumbing it. And then a really easy little kick to Ruffy.
Well, we find out a lot about Melbourne right now, and we find out Hawthorn have been so good in this area, winning these really close games over the years. And right now, they're just in front. This is a really, really good game.
Bob Jane, T-Marts, Mickey R.
Yeah, heavy hit on Wagner. Came to the bench, sitting down with the doctor, dry reaching. He's really struggling to breathe. Just got belted.
Yeah, crunched in a marking contest. Did well to get up for McDonald's. Triple M rocks footy. Gibson off the back of the square. But Melbourne with the answers in the air to Bernie Vince. Immediately spreads it on the boot to Viney. One of Melbourne's best. Looping hand pass. Puts Pedersen under all sorts of pressure. Stratton applies the tackle. Viney tries to make up for the hand pass. Takes on the tacklers one too many times. He's pinned there, Viney. The Hawks will get it middle of the ground on the wing.
Yeah, just tried to butter up his original bad mistake with the handball to Pedersen, did Viney. Got tackled well. Burton takes the mark from Langford. Round the grounds.
We've got the Bombers leading the Dockers by 20 points deep into the second quarter.
10.5 to go this final turn. Mark will be taken by Stratton just inside the interchange gates. Still a long way to go. Hartung gets the kick from Stratton. Lays the handball off to Burton. Slides the kick across half back and goes to Burgoyne.
Uncontested marks up again for Hawks. 2 minutes.
Four times as many. 16-4 this quarter.
Yep.
Burgoyne, defensive side of the square. He wants to short it. Now he's called to play on. Most players will be in trouble in this situation. He normally thinks his way through it, and he does this time by hand. The Hawks just stymied across half-back at the moment. They go to O'Brien, who's played one of his, if not his best game for the Hawks today. Gives it short to Isaac Smith. Out of wing. Bernie Vince stands the mark. Smith just takes a bit of time out of the game. Wanted a short option, one didn't present, so he's going to land it. 30 from home in the pocket. Sicily flies, can't take the mark. This man, Frost, who has been brilliant, takes on defenders. Not his best hand pass, though. Smith managed to bring the ball to ground inside the Hawks' attack, 50.
But who lays the tackle? Frost, a great tackle. And we'll have a thrown up 49 out from Hawthorne's goal. Frost has been unbelievable. And the ball in Hawthorne's forward 50. They lead by 7 points. Melbourne have been gallant to get back into this position. But it's at the wrong end. Jones, head over the prune. Tries to bullock his way through a couple of Hawks. And he's wrapped up and will have it thrown up 45 out from the Hawks goal.
Domain Stadium, near map aerial imagery.
Bombers by 21 points over the Dockers. Howie, deep into that second quarter.
Earlier on today.
Yeah, Sydney too good for the Lions, defeating them by 54 points. Buddy with 8 goals.
Ooh, the big bud with a big bag. Ball tight on the boundary line. Not going anywhere. 40 round from the Hawks goal. They led by 27 at quarter time, Hawthorn. 29 at the half. It got out to 35 points in the third quarter till Melbourne got it to 1 point at three quarter time. And it's currently a 7-point margin. And the ball will be tossed in 40 round from the Hawks goals.
A lot of players around the pill. Biggest lead of the game today, too. 35 points when Ruffhead got goal number two.
Exactly right, Swatter.
Early stages, third quarter. Umpire hurls it back in. Ruffhead in the ruck. Vince had it, lost it. Langford has a crack. So does Pedersen. Comes up with the ball, but Langford follows up with a good tackle. Willing game of footy in this second half, and we'll have it thrown up. 45 out from Hawthorn's goal. Punt road in, they attack.
Rowley, he stood by Jetta inside 50. Danger for the Demons. Ruckhead just pushed out of the ruck contest by Pedersen. Fairley, Mitchell, Petrarca burst through to Lewis. Has kicked a goal against his old side. Burgoyne bounced off Viney. Couple of hard nuts. Now there is Rioli. He is loose. Size one inside 50. What a mark that was. Back with the flight by Oscar McDonald. Put his body on the line and did something for the Melbourne Footy Club.
Hibbard squeezed the kick. Got it to Frost. Handball to Lewis through the corridor. Back to Frost. He wants the ball. He demands it and he gets it. And just an inside-outside barrel. Unbloody believable. Goes inside 50. Mark is dropped. Couple of Hawks collide. They dodge it though. They weave it and they share it around. Good play.
Running through half back the Hawks. They find Sicily on the wing. Puopolo's vacant if he can find him there. Takes his time. Now goes really short. Finds Puopolo, who's got Gunston as well, if you can go that way. Ruffhead saying, get it to me, though. I've got four. That's what he does. Ruffy's got a one-on-one. Player arrives late, though, but I reckon Ruffhead's been held. And he has, and he's going to get a free kick. Hibbert cannot believe it. And Ruffy will line up from about 30 out, 45-degree angle. What'd you see on the Triple M Chemist Warehouse replay, boys?
Just having a look. Oh, soft. Ruffy's got a couple of gifts today. A couple of gifts. Not a lot in that.
He's kicked four. He's kicked four, the big rough. This to take it out to a 13-point margin. Tight angle. It's all about accuracy. Trots in. Slides it right. Disappointing by the Hawks skipper. Hawthorn, 13-9-87. Melbourne, 12-7-79. Back out to 8 points. Triple M Exetel scoreboard.
7:06 to play. 79-87, Hawks lead round the grounds.
Bombers by 20 points over the Dockers nearing half-time.
Bernie Vince will go to Jack Watts with Hodge. Can get it out the back door. Hunt's there. Hodge did well to corral it. Sicily's there as well. Hodge is desperate on his hands and knees. We'll have it thrown up at half-forward.
Luke Hodge wasn't letting that one out of there. Brought it to ground 2-on-1. Jumped on the footy and Jack Watts. Just a bit of push and shove. How long on the clock?
6:50 remaining, Howie.
Thank you, Chu. We'll get an update from the football in a moment. It's the round ball game. Ball on the one, wing to be won. Inside out from the Demons. They push it forward. It's bouncing towards the boundary line. Hunt and Gibson. Gibson will want the boundary line. Does well. Keeps it in. Hand pass it to no one in particular. Hodge picks it up. Getting word through that the victory might have scored two early doors against Sydney FC. Now the Hawks on the wing. Burgoyne looping hand pass to Sicily. Sees a man inside 50. Doesn't go that way now. Could have. McAvoy, the running Isaac Smith from 45. Loves it. Big goal, Smith. Hawks with a bit of breathing space. Hawthorn 14-9-93. Melbourne 12-7-79. Hawthorn by 14 points. On the Triple M Exetel scoreboard.
Now, full credit to the Hawks defenders. With its glass half full, I'm going to go with the glass half full rather than the Melbourne forwards being terrible, Duck. Yeah. And the last three or four entries have been really poor for the Melbourne forwards. But full credit to the Hawk defenders. They're taking really aggressive position. They're getting across and helping their man Gibson on hand and then terrific body work.
Yep.
Knocked him off. Defenders getting across to help. And then all of a sudden the ball goes down the other end of the ground. So well done, Hawks defenders, and very good running by Isaac Smith.
14-point lead to Hawthorn. 6:15 to go. Final turn, bouncing ball off the back of the square. Hodge, the skipper, former, tumbles it towards the current. Ruffhead will come late. Jetta was good. Got it to Salem. Ruffhead, a bone-jarring tackle. Ball spills free. Oliver's there through the feet of Lewis. Head over the prune. That was Gibson. Comes to Viney. Goes to Bernie Vince. He's away.
Melbourne got a bit of a problem with the clock now. A-League Grand Final, two.
Goal to Melbourne victory thanks to Berisha.
Ah, Berisha.
The 21st 21 minutes into the first half. How is her victory 1-0 up?
Always gets it done in the A-League Grand Final. He's won a few of them and scored in a few of them. Meanwhile, Melbourne back here. More importantly, the G get it to Tyson. Outer wing. They trail by 14 points, the Demons, with 5.5 on the clock. They go inboard to Jetta. He gives it to Bernie Vince from 55. Chips the top of the square. Hogan, big shove on his man. Umpire says it's a mark. Burton not strong enough to stop big Jesse Hogan. And this to get the Demons right back in it as Hogan lines up for his third directly in front, 20 out.
It's interesting, though, isn't it? With the 18-man defences now, Duck, you've got Burton versus Hogan. And that's happened a number of times. Yep. Frawley goes to someone else. Burton takes Hogan, and he probably kicks a goal here, Howie.
He's kicked two, Jesse. Should make no mistake. No problems, Demons. Back in it. Hawthorn 14-9-93. Melbourne 13-7-85. 8-point margin. Hawks up. 4:44 to go. Final term. Triple M Excel scoreboard. Bob Jane, T-Marts, Mickey Roberts.
Last four contests, around 40,000 for these two sides. Today, 38,693, Howie.
Yeah, you're right, Roosie. That's all you want as a key forward. You just want one-on-ones. You just want to get it in there quickly. Maybe a little bit lucky, Hogan. Maybe a little bit of a push in the back. So got away with one there. But good finish and good composure. What are the centre clearances, Chu Man? Because this one is massive for Melbourne.
Yeah, 15 to 10, Melbourne's way.
4:42 to go. Final term. 8-point lead, Hawthorne's way. Hogan's got three. For McDonald's, Triple M Rocks footy. Pedersen, McAvoy, Oliver. Been prolific, so has Viney. Hawthorn free kick. High contact. Goes to Mitchell, the former Swan. Inside the centre square. Having to just dice off some valuable time on the clock. 4:34 and continuing a countdown. Mitchell goes out wide. The mark will be taken by Burt.
Still a lot of time on the clock. Hawks don't want to be too cute. They give it to Mitchell, defensive side of the wing. Just repeating that Melbourne victory leads Sydney FC by a goal. Early doors from Bessart Berisha. The Hawks drive it long. Attack the side of the wing. Big fly from O'Brien. That's a genuine hanger out there. Really good mark above the pack by Tim O'Brien. Taking a handful of contested marks. They go on further, Hawks, through Hartung. Important contest right to the teeth of goal. Rough head, it might be there. Just one behind. Melbourne, 85. Hawthorn, 94. 4 minutes or so on the clock. Triple M Excel scoreboard. Contested marks to Tim O'Brien at 8-2.
Four.
That'll be four.
I think it was four.
I think it's four.
Yep, we've got 3:47 to go. Final term, two-goal ball game for the Demons. Garlett stepped his way through traffic. Got to go now. Jones, handball, Viney. Intercepted.
Burgoyne the day there.
Cool, calm and collected. Goes back to Gibson, who takes the mark.
Gee, the Demons are away there. What'd you see, Roosie? What happened to the Viney handball?
Well, it's been the story of the day, just the overuse of the handball. It's certainly hurt them at critical times.
Burton to Hartung. 3:24 on the clock. The Hawks lead by 9 points.
Have to man up here, and exactly that. They've got to win the ball back here, Melbourne.
Big contest on the wing. Lewis and O'Brien. Now Sicily tries to mop up. Tracks back with the ball. Mitchell, he'll just look for a short option. He does that, and the Hawks will take a bit off the clock. Burton's got it right back flank.
Have to man up. Can't allow this Hawthorn to wear the clock down. So they have to make him kick down the line. They do.
3 minutes to go. Seabus Super Special comments from the King, Wayne Carey. Good mark back of the pack,
five,
O'Brien.
Five.
As opposed to
four.
O'Brien on the outer wing. Off a step. High ball to half forward. Rough locks onto it. Couldn't take the mark. Bernie Vince is there. Got boot to ball. Big boy McAvoy will do the roving. Funnels the handball out. Burgoyne always got time. Caresses the ball. Burton. Hot handball though. Getting his man was Hannon on the southern wing.
Really important ball. 2:22 on the clock. The Hawks lead by 9 points. He has paid holding the ball. Melbourne need two goals in the last 2 minutes.
Well, you can tell the body language and the umpire. Yeah, they just stand there.
Yeah. Salem pushes the ball forward. Really risky ball in the middle of the ground. The Hawks will mop up through Rioli. Takes on the tackler to Gibson. The Hawks just trying to get it in their hands and hold up time. It's a risky caper because now Hunt's got a chance. The speedster outside 50. Nate Jones. Hand passes to Garlett. Already been impressive. Got three in the third term. Inside 50 ball. Hawks got the answers. Fisted away towards the boundary line. Hunt somehow keeps it in. Hodge now attacks Hunt. in his defensive zone. Needs to get rid of it, the Hawks ex-skipper, and does.
Yep, they dive in on top. Ball goes towards the boundary line. They keep it alive. Got to go, Petrarca. He centres the ball. He's got a man. It's the former Hawk. Lewis takes the mark. 1:29 to play. Got to get on his skates. Got to go back and nail the goal. Goal. If there any chance, he has to kick at the premiership superstar. Oh boy.
What a dream.
What a dream. How he had one last night about pressure. Corley kicking the first goal, and victory have done that.
Your old club.
Lewis.
Massive moment.
1:12, 1:10. Continuing to count down. If he kicks it, they'll have 60 seconds. And he's nailed the goal. Hawthorn. Lead by 3 points. We have 58 seconds, 56 seconds on the clock to play. Triple M Exetel scoreboard.
Tell you what, Frawley, the double fister.
Yeah, was that
punch.
Frawley? Yeah.
Double fister.
Double fister.
Mark the footy, son.
Yeah. Yeah, if you can get too mixed to it.
Yep.
I agree.
55 second on the clock. Hawthorn led this game by 35 points midway through the third quarter in front of 38,693 people. It is back to a 3-point margin the way of the Hawks. 55 seconds. McDonald's Triple M rocks footy. Who's going to get the centre clearance? McAvoy gets it down. Jones gets it to Bernie Vince. The Demons have got it. Hibbert wants to get it on his boot. Burgoyne, massive tackle. O'Brien arrives late. He's caught. Melbourne have moved it 15 metres in the right way. There's 46 seconds on the clock, and they're 70 from home.
43.
Ruffy sitting behind there. What a
Pedersen. Can the D's get a clearance? They can. Hibbard throws it on the boot. It's more in hope than anything. They'll fly. A big pack forms. Loose ball. Burgoyne. A critical gather. An even more important give. Got it off to Sicily. Wheels around. Got the kick away. High ball towards the broadcast wing.
Big fly from behind by Shearer. But it's Frost, who's had an unbelievable night. Plays on immediately to Bernie Vince.
Oh, he had to
26
give the
on the clock. You've got to go, Bernie.
Oh.
23 seconds on the clock. Goes one further short to Salem.
Oh.
Less than 20 on the clock.
Got to go.
Salem. Ball inside 50. Melbourne. They need a mark. Big pack of players fisted towards the boundary line. Top clock ticking down. Jack Watts sees it across with 6 seconds on the clock. Melbourne 50 from home. They trail by 3 points. 2 seconds on the clock.
They're home, Hawthorn. The ball will come in. Siren will sound. And the Hawks will notch up their second win of the season. That's it. Hawthorn, gutsy, brave, and they managed to hang on. 14-10-94 against the gallon outfit Melbourne, 14-7-91.
Led by 27 at quarter time, 29 at the half. Melbourne reduced it just to a 1-point margin at three quarter time. In the end, Hawthorn 14-10-94, Melbourne 14-7-91. The Hawks by 3 points. Rough hit with 4 for the victors. Hogan kicked 2, Garlick kicked 3, and Hunt kicked 2 for the Melbourne Footy Club. Entertaining game of football. The Hawks all around Jordan Lewis out in the middle of the ground on the Triple M Chemist Warehouse replay screen. Josh Gibson chatting to him. Burton as well. He's got a smile on his face, Geordie Lewis. Wonderful game of football. And the Hawks get their second win of the season, and a tough one to digest for the Demons.
Yeah, look, I think the big stat for me too, man, is tackles. Look, Hawthorn had 44 last week, and they're up to 82.
82.
Yeah. Now, you can cope with a loss in contested ball, which is still pretty catastrophic, but they've tackled well.
Daisy Pearce out in the middle, thanks to 7 with Luke Hodge.
Did you manage to cross paths with Geordie during the game, and were any words said?
Nah, not much. No. I think we tangled a little bit over there on the ground and both got up with a bit of a smile, but I think it was disappointing not to play against Mitch a couple weeks ago because he was injured, but the sort of runner against Louis. We've got that much of a history with the footy club. Sort of, you can't really get too angry or dirty at him.
Yeah,
we'll give it just as good back.
Must have been strange, but nervous right to the end. You must be happy with the response, the turnaround from last week.
Yeah, I think last week was a bit frustrating. I think with the side we've got, new guys coming in, young guys playing, we're going to have some ups and downs. And it was West Coast up last week, it was a shocking down. Even in today's game, we had ups and downs as well. So, but we've just got to stick to what we know, stick to what Clarko is teaching us, help develop the young guys, and we're just looking to improve and keep going.
Well, all the best with it. Good luck next week.
Thank you.
Thank you to the Seven Network, Luke Hodge and Daisy Pearce. Hawthorn by 3 points over Melbourne.
Yeah, they got their uncontested marks up, Duck 2 in the last quarter. But tackles and contested marks were very, very good for Hawthorn.
Yeah, they were telling, weren't they? McAvoy, a couple of really big, strong ones. And obviously O'Brien might have, I know you said at the start, Howie, and I'm not sure whether Clarko has said it publicly, but, you know, I think they need to play him. You can really see he's got some talent, got really good mitts, kicks the ball really well, and probably the best game I've seen him play at this level.
Yeah, he was absolutely fantastic tonight. To a lot of contested marks.
Five.
Joe Ruff head out with Daisy Pearce. Five.
Plenty of ups and downs this year, but always good to get a win.
Oh, yeah, especially after the past couple of weeks being so up and down. It's good to put four quarters together. Even though the third quarter they still kicked seven goals, we were still within the game and probably could have had a few more shots ourselves.
What's the key now to turning that into consistent performances now with this new group?
Oh, that's the key. I think just believing that we can do it for four quarters. You know, we can't just think that one week's going to make it all better. We've got to make sure that we then look forward to next week, Brisbane down in Tassie. So, you know, look forward to that and get down there and hopefully get another.
Well, good luck against the Lions next week.
Thank you very much. Good luck to you too.
Oh, Ruffy just dishing out a nice little good luck to Daisy Pearce. The Hawks 3-point winners earlier on today. Brisbane went down to Sydney. Buddy kicked eight. The Swans won by
54 points, Howie.
And currently near map aerial imagery around the grounds.
Okay, so it's half time out in the west. So the Bombers 7-7-49, leading the Dockers by 13 points, 5-6. 36.
And the A-League Grand Final, he who scores when it counts.
Your boy Berisha scored at the 21-minute mark, and we're 35 minutes into the first half. Melbourne victory, 1-0.
I tell you what, Roosie, I know we're about the AFL here, but if Sydney, after the season they've had, they only lost one game, had a massive year all year. If they get rolled in the Grand Final, it will be one of the bigger upsets we've seen.
Well, that's a big deficit, 1-0 in soccer, isn't it?
It is. It is, Roosie. Really, C-Bus super stuff from Roosie there on the round ball game.
I'll qualify that. I don't know anything about soccer.
Oh, really?
No, but 1-0 is a big deficit.
Thank you for that, Roosie. What did you see here today? Thanks for that.
It's been a year and a half of upsets, Howie.
Oh, it has. And, I'm glad that our man Roosie's not working on the round ball game from what he's just given us there.
Well, I mean, again, we're getting back to the stats and trying to pick the reason Hawthorn won. And I believe they improved their tackling. The contested ball was still down. But huge numbers from Melbourne too, man. I mean, they just had an enormous amount of the ball, didn't they?
Look at this. Look at the handballs, Roosie. Exactly 100 more handballs than Hawthorn. 238 to 138. Overall, their handball to kick ratio, 238 handballs to 194 kicks.
Yeah, so, Duck, you touched on it a few times during the game. It's just that balance. Once they got the balance right, Melbourne, they look a far more effective team. If they overhandball, that's when they get themselves into trouble.
Yeah, they did. And then, and what it is it's when Hawthorn lifted their pressure in that last quarter, then that handball, that does become a problem for them. And when Hawthorn's pressure wasn't, at its strongest in that third quarter, that's when Melbourne really got on top and their decision-making was a little bit better as well. But they've just got to work out that it's, you're right, it's at the end of the day it comes down to decision making.
And I think the last quarter, Duck's telling, obviously, because we thought I hope Melbourne were coming, but if you look at the figures in the last quarter, contested possession, Melbourne were only plus four, two men.
Yeah.
So that's manageable. They won the tackles 22-16, and they won the inside 50s 10-8. So their last quarters that have struggled were actually, the last quarter was good today for them.
Right. Conceded 95 points, and the kick-to-handball ratio started to fluctuate again, 52 handballs to 40 kicks.
Les Murray on the phone, just trying to track down Roosie's number to possibly get him across to the round ball for some special comments. Downstairs, Mickey Roberts. Robbo, the Hawks in quickly, Grant Birchall.
Yeah, Birchall just walked past me, so I'm going to go get to him because they say that it could be a PCL. He's had history before, 2013. L. Clarkson. In. I tell you what, look to me, smiles at Clark. I think it's a relieved L. Clarkson. They got over the line because they, what were they, 35, 36 points up at three-quarter time after Roughhead's goal. And scores were even and they had to fight to win this one. So they're pretty happy. They're buggered, but they're going to belt this song out. Here they go.
Where the money goes. We are
and get Ruffy too, the captain, after this.
Well done, Robbo. Working nicely down there. We've got the votes coming through at some point. Who's got which tonight?
I'm going to take the bat. I'm not going to allow...
Yeah, that's fair. I appreciate that. I'll remember that, Duck.
I'm not going to allow the man that coached this team to have the bad
votes. I'll remember that.
Roosie, why don't you whip your way through the good votes and then we'll get to an interview and then Duck and round things up.
Look, it's an interesting game. I always like to give the votes to man, and I always like your help because you're expertise. I always like to give them to the winning team, even though I probably felt that maybe Melbourne had the better players. But I really liked... I mean, Tommy Mitchell has had 31. I just thought some really critical. He's hard. He's in and under. I thought he was really good. I thought Luke Hodge was really good, and I thought Roughhead was really good. So why don't we... Do you want to go with those three, or do you want to stick a Melbourne player in?
No, if you're going to stick a Melbourne player in, maybe a Viney.
I thought Viney was their best. Yeah. So what do you think?
32 touches. I'd give Viney one.
All right, we'll give Viney one. Well, who's going to miss out for the Hawks then?
Miss out for the Hawks? That's a very good question. I would,
the four goals for Ruffy, I'm going to say,
lock him in.
They are telling. We've got to lock him in. Oh, I reckon Tommy Mitchell's going to be stiff because I think Luke Hodge, I thought his game, Duck, what do you, what, anyone?
Yeah, no, Hodge.
And I'm saying Tommy lived with me in Sydney for a while, so I've got to apologise for that. But I'm going with one for Viney, two for Hodge. Sorry, two for Roughhead and three for Hodgie.
I like it.
Okay, couldn't squeeze Cyril in. I haven't seen the stats. But
Not with 12 possessions and no goals.
Cyril might.
Just checking, Roosie.
Cyril might get votes.
Just checking. Hey. There's some things you don't do. Earlier on today, Sydney had a win, although I fear after the Hawks win that they will stay on the bottom of the ladder. While we're here, Chewy, because we've only got one game to go, why don't you pull up the ladder and just give us a nice little run through while we're waiting for Robbo down there. Who sits where and what's happening, please?
Okay, hang on. Before you go on, I've just got a stat here for you. 1-0 behind in a soccer game, you've got a 1% chance of winning. So, in effect, that is a big win. That is a big lead, as I said before, Howie. So, just confirming that with Chewy.
Bosch tool stat of the day, that one.
Yeah, there's a little bit of mayonnaise on that one, but I like it. But nevertheless, the victory are in front. 1-0 thanks to Bessart Berisha. Ladder, Chew.
Yeah, top of the table, the Adelaide Crows. So six wins. And,
oh, hang on, Chew. I reckon Melbourne victory might have just equalised. I'm looking on a screen a long way away from me. But what about 1-1? Because that's
well,
what the
score is. Well, that stats has changed now. We'll deliver that after the ladder, Chew, man.
I'm not exactly sure, actually. I'm looking at a screen 3 blocks away. So we'll get a word on that in the moment. But I think, actually, I'm looking at a replay. So victory, I don't know what's happening.
No,
we'll go to another ground in a minute.
It's still 1-0.
I think it's half time, and they're showing highlights.
Very difficult to score at half time. I do know that in a soccer game.
You just fix to what we're doing.
Just get rid of the last 20 seconds of conversation.
Crows on top, 6 wins, 1 loss. And then we have, 5 teams with 5 wins and 2 losses. We've got the Giants sitting second, followed by Geelong, West Coast 4th, Bulldogs and Richmond, rounding out the 8 with 4 wins and 3 losses, Port Adelaide and St Kilda. Outside of the 8 on percentage are the Bombers. That's assuming if they were to defeat the Dockers, they'd be on 4 wins. If they lose, I'll still be outside of the 8. And then we have a cluster of teams with 3 wins and 4 losses. That's Melbourne sitting 10th, followed by the Suns, Carlton and the Dockers, who are sitting 13th, provided they lose to the Bombers. And then North Melbourne with 2 wins sitting 14th, Collingwood and the Hawks, who are sitting 16th, also have registered 2 wins. And then the bottom 2 teams, Sydney sitting 17th with the 1 solitary win, and Brisbane last on the ladder also with 1 win.
All right, Ducky boy.
Difficult day to give out. None of us like doing this, but Chew Man has certainly loaded the gun.
I gave
one vote to Buggy for Melbourne. I just didn't think he had a massive influence for the D's today. Didn't get involved enough. I gave 2 votes to Shields, who I think he only had it 13, 14 times, Chew Man. Went at 33%, so not a big influence by him. And 3 votes I gave to a man who I absolutely love.
Oh, yeah.
Just didn't have an impact today. Didn't hit the scoreboard. I'm not sure how many kicks. Only a couple of kicks, I think.
Three
kicks for Poppy. So, just wasn't a great day. Well, we know they've won premierships, Howie, but there was no premierships won today.
Well, Ducky's been in good form. We started singing in the middle of special comments today. Now, stick around on Triple M Football, because after this, we are going to the Essendon-Fremantle game. I can confirm it is 1-0 at half-time. Victory leading Sydney FC. Well done to everyone in the box today. You've done a magnificent job to everyone back in the studio. You take it easy, Swatty. You have a nice Sunday night. 60 minutes normally for Ducco. And Reezy, you go back and watch the football. Everyone else, I think you can get out of here. But here at the MCG, Melbourne 14-7, 91, going down to the Hawks by 3 points. Hawthorn 14-10, 94. The Hawks with their second win of the season.